baseball that they played all year right out here this afternoon. The Tigers have not yet made their appearance. And
they're down at the tunnel now, though. They're ready to come out.
And the big banner is here.
Earlier, the captains, Gary Atkins and Rocky Myrick for the Tigers, met at midfield with the Notre Dame captains, Vegas Ferguson, Dave Wehmer, along with Tim Foley. And, of course, the toss of the coin taking place. And Notre Dame winning it, electing to receive, and the Tigers electing to defend the south end of the stadium, taking the wind here in the first quarter of play. Now the Tigers on the field, and you can hear the roar of better than 5,000 Tiger fans, and the balloons go up just as they would at Death Valley. Danny Ford has talked all week about the fact that he wanted it to be like Death Valley here today. Well, right now it is very, very similar. The only thing lacking is about 5,000 people. So that's about how many short they are of a capacity down at Death Valley. 59,075 here. Maybe they're making up for that back at Littlejohn this afternoon. A couple of persons like to say hello to. Yank Barano. Yank, good to hear that you're coming along fine. And a couple of weeks ago, we, of course, talked to you on this network and happy to speak to you again today. And Doc McClellan said to get ready for next week. Wants to see you down there at that Carolina-Clemson game. Want to say hello to Bill Ware in Varnville. Bill is the father of Billy Ware, one of the Tiger assistants, and recovering, and certainly we hope well on his way back to good health. And Diane Andrews, who is the wife of Mickey Andrews. Ill and unable to make the trip. This was one of the wives, or the wives' trip this year, the one that they call their official trip of the year. Diane, very sorry that you couldn't make the trip, but hope that you enjoy the football game this afternoon. Below us, Notre Dame. Back in receiving position, the Tigers' Obed Ariri will be placing it on the tee as Notre Dame sends back as their deep backs, Jim Stone to the near side and Ty Barber to the far side. Brilliant, sunshiny day here at Notre Dame Stadium. The team arrived yesterday. Temperatures were in the mid-40s, and some of them said, hey, is it going to get cold up here tomorrow? But overnight, a warmer front came in, and we're expecting temperatures to reach 60 degrees here this afternoon. Just a gorgeous day for football. So Ariri has it placed to his satisfaction at the 40-yard line. Stone and Barber backed up to the goal line for Notre Dame. Now the football topples off the tee, as it's prone to do on occasion. Immediately below us, Dan Devine and the Notre Dame team. Dressed in their Kelly green, trimmed in yellow, with the brilliant gold helmets atop their heads. Now Ariri approaching the football, high end-over-end kick. Going to be grabbed off by Stone at the 8. Out over the 10, up the near side at the 15. Gets to the 20, finds a shot at the 30. 35. Finally pulled down as he moves out to the 43-yard line. Good wall of blocking along the near side. And finally, getting to him was Jamie Pope to put him down. But Notre Dame starting with excellent field position as they have the football at their own 43-yard line. So it will be Rusty Lish and company coming out to see what they can do offensively with the football. Sweeney will be at fullback. Vegas Ferguson, the halfback. Houlihan goes wide to the left side. Lish up under center down. Long count at the line of scrimmage. Takes out. Rides it off to Ferguson. Sprints to his left, and he's hit as he gets out to the 45-yard line. Up quickly defensively for the Tigers, David Reed from his right defensive end position and linebacker Jeff Davis. They have marked the football at the 44.5-yard line, so call it a gain of one. It will be second down and 9. Sweeney is out, and in at fullback now is Phil Carter. To the near side comes Houlihan. They line up in the eye. Lish again up under center, takes out. This time rides it off to Ferguson. Once more, he dives off right tackle, and he is hit hard by Steve Durham as he crosses the 45 to about the 46-yard line. Durham was the first in there. Then Eddie Gethers came up to aid on the tackle. And they have marked it at the 45, so it's negligible, if any, gain on the play. Well, now they move it on out to the 47. Thought they had spotted it badly there.
Jim, Tigers number 8 in the nation right now in rushing defense, giving up 109.9 per game.
Third and 7, Notre Dame. Houlihan goes wide to the left side. Lish at quarterback, moves up under center again. Once more, the long count at the line of scrimmage, and there comes Charlie Bauman. He jumped. I don't know whether he was drawn offside or whether he came of his own volition. Maybe anticipating that time. Going to be against the Tigers, so Bauman anticipating that time, jumped offside. So that will give Notre Dame five more yards. It'll move the ball into Tiger territory at the 48-yard line and now brings out third and just a bit less than 2 yards. So that changes the complexion of this play. Once again, Notre Dame comes out. Houlihan wide to the right side. Sweeney is a fullback. Vegas Ferguson, the tailback. Now Lish takes out, rides it off to Ferguson. Hit at the 50 and may have a first. No, I don't think he has. He's going to be stopped shy of a first down as he's hit right around the 48-yard line by Bobby Goldberg, who came up from his defensive end position. Someone had him back around the 49 of Notre Dame. He slipped a tackle there, but he did not get the necessary yardage for the first down.
Tiger defense passed a real test. They had great field position. A penalty almost gave him a first down, but they were able to hold him.
Dick Buschka back to do the punting as Hollis Hall drops back deep for the Tigers to receive. Again, a little bit of anticipation on the defense. Buschka's kick, a floater, going to be grabbed off by Willie Underwood, the up back, at the 19-yard line, and that's where the Tigers will put it in play for the first time this afternoon. A 29-yard punt into the wind by Buschka, and the Tigers take over the football, first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
Okay, if you notice, the Irish more or less wanted to attack the corners on the Tigers more than anywhere else because of the lack of success anybody's had running straight at them.
It'll be Marvin Sims and Lester Brown in the eye behind Billy Lott as Perry Tuttle comes wide to the left side. First offensive play of the afternoon for the Tigers. Lott moves up under center now, takes out. Back, rolls to his left, looks to throw downfield for Tuttle. Deflected away, good defensive play by Dave Wehmer, the cornerback. Threw the ball just a fraction late. That's a time pattern there, and Tuttle, as he turned, looked as if he were open, but Wehmer, doing a good job, coming across, was able to tip it away, and it's now second and 10 Tigers at the 19-yard line. Tuttle checks out, getting into the ball game now is Gilliard. He comes wide to the left side. Brian Clark tight end to the right, Mark Clifford to the left. Second down, 10 Tigers at their own 19. Lott takes out, gives to Marvin Sims, finds some running room, out over the 25 to the 27-yard line goes Marvin Sims before he is hauled down. And in there defensively, Mike Whittington and Bob Crable, left and middle linebacker for Notre Dame. So now it will be third down, 2 yards to go for the Tigers, the ball at their own 27-yard line. Tuttle checks back in, brings the play with him from the bench. 12 minutes, 17 seconds remaining in the first quarter of play here at Notre Dame Stadium. And a lot of orange representing Tiger fans here today. Lott has them in the eye again on third and two. Billy takes out, pitch back to Lester Brown, sweeping to his right. He's got first down as he's out over the 30 to the 31-yard line, and out of bounds he goes. Dave Durson, the cornerback, came across to knock him down. However, Lester gets first down. They have spotted the football just across the 30-yard line.
Jim, Notre Dame's giving up 187 yards a game as far as rushing is concerned. And there again, the success has been attack their corners, attack the corners.
All right. Clemson with three wideouts. Tuttle and Gilliard come to the left side. Eric Young goes to the right side. Billy Lott, quarterback, has them in the eye at the 31-yard line. Takes out, gives to Marvin Sims, out over the 35. Marvin out to the 39-yard line before he is pulled down. And up defensively for Notre Dame this time, leading the way was Bobby Leopold, the right side linebacker. But Marvin Sims, running hard behind Nanny and Dulcey that time, gets it out to the 39-yard line where it'll be second and two. Out they come. Tuttle, Joey Smith to the left side. Eric Young goes wide to the right side. From the eye, Billy Lott moves up under center now. Takes the snap. Again, off to Sims. Marvin gets one, and that's it. As he's hit hard as he gets to the 40-yard line, he'll be knocked down just shy of a first down. And leading the charge defensively again was Leopold, with defensive end Joe Gramke joining in.
Jim, they went from a three-down lineman set that time to four.
Notre Dame bringing Zavagnin in now at left linebacker as Whittington comes to the sidelines and ailing a bit. It is a first down. I didn't think he had enough yardage for it, but they have measured now, and Marvin Sims did, in fact, get a first down as he crossed the 40. His forward progress carried him to that point, and that's where the ball was spotted. So the Tigers have driven from their own 19 now out to the 40-yard line, just across the 40. Tuttle goes wide to the left. Gilliard will slot to the left side, and again, Eric Young goes to the right. High formation behind Billy Lott at quarterback. Lott setting them down now. Sends in motion Gilliard to the right side. Rides it off the tailback Lester Brown. He'll squirm his way forward to the 44-yard line, and down he goes there. Up defensively for Notre Dame this time is Pat Kramer. So Lester gets about four. It'll be second down and six now for the Tigers.
Right now the Tigers controlling the line of scrimmage. They're firing off the ball so fast. They're having to out quick because they certainly are outweighed.
All right, this time Tuttle goes wide right. Joey Smith will be a slot to the right side. To the left, Eric Young. High formation again. Billy Lott at quarterback. Second down six, Tigers 44-yard line. Marvin Sims straight ahead. That's it. Knocked down at about the 45-yard line. That time it just did not open up as Notre Dame stacked in there with Zedek and Kramer and were able to stop Sims at the 45-yard line. So now it'll be third down and five.
Well, here's the big play of the ball game so far. Can the Tigers keep it alive? Notre Dame's defense has got to toughen up right here for them.
Tuttle goes wide right. Gilliard a slot to the right side. Young splits off left end. Lott is back to throw, rolling to his right. Looks downfield, fires. This one is incomplete, intended for Tuttle at the 38-yard line of Notre Dame, but there to break it up was Dave Wehmer, and now David Sims will be called upon to do the punting as the Tigers are stopped and now must turn it back over to Notre Dame. They'll drop back two backs.
Sims averaging 44-9, number five in the nation.
Ty Dickerson on the near side and Dave Durison on the far side, back as twin receivers for Notre Dame. Here's Sims' kick. He hits a beauty. It's going to be grabbed off back around the 8-yard line and in a bit of trouble back there, and finally out of bounds goes Ty Dickerson at the 13-yard line. Make it. That was a 48-yard punt by David Sims, and downfield quickly was Scott Jackson to make the hit and knock him out of bounds. So the Irish backed up now at their own 13-yard line and a hand for their offense as they come to the field. And down below us, we have a timeout. So with timeout on the field, 9:41 remaining in the first quarter, there is no score in this football game.
This is the Clemson Football Network.
Jim, I shortchanged David Sims. I said he was number five in the nation. Actually, he's number three in the stats that were handed me just before the ball game. I looked it up again. He's number three with a 44.9.
Well, he didn't hurt it any with that 48-yarder he just boomed out then, I'll tell you that. Notre Dame has the football at their own 13-yard line, first and 10. Wide to the left side, they'll send Tony Hunter. He's been outstanding as a freshman receiver. Split backfield, Sweeney and Ferguson. And now the officials step back in. One of them was out of place over along the Clemson sidelines there. And so Notre Dame will retreat back to the huddle. 59,075. It's the attendance every time Notre Dame plays at home. Has been for years now. Hunter wide to the left side. Ferguson left and Sweeney to the right in the split backfield behind quarterback Rusty Leish. This time it's off to Ferguson. He finds a little running room. Gets out over the 15 to the 18-yard line. And down he goes there. Jack Kane was up along with Steve Durham. And there is a flag back around the 10-yard line. Offside against the Irish on that play. So they'll call the Tigers in now. Bubba Brown, defensive representative out there, the captain of that defensive unit. I'm sure the Tigers will take this penalty. That will set it back to the 8-yard line. It'll bring about first down and 15.
You know, Jim, when Ferguson got his hands on the ball, he took it and held it down to his side. I was looking for some kind of reverse or something to unfold on that particular play. He held it very loosely.
Well, he may have been looking for reverse, too. Maybe setting something up for later on. Hunter again goes wide to the left side. Now they'll work from the eye with Ferguson in the tailback spot. Leish at quarterback sends a man in motion. Then a straight dive, Carter, Phil Carter. Diving straight ahead, crosses the 10 out to about the 12-yard line and is pulled down there. Checking back in now is John Sweeney at fullback. And Carter comes out of there. Second down, 9 yards to go, or second down, 11 yards to go for Notre Dame. The ball at their own 12-yard line. Houlihan wide to the left side. splitting Hunter to the right side. Split backfield behind Rusty Leish. Leish dropping the throw. First pass of the afternoon, deep over the middle, complete. Grabbing it off is Houlihan. He's out over the 40 to the 42-yard line. Fumbles the football, and the Tigers have it.
Somebody just took it away, Jim.
David Reed came up with that football. Leish went back, and boy, that Houlihan is some receiver. I thought when he delivered the football, he had thrown it far too high, but Houlihan got up into the air, came down with the reception, and lost the football when he went down. The Tigers have it at the 41-yard line of the Irish, first and 10. Wide to the right side goes Tuttle. Gilliard will be in a slot. To the left side, they sprint Eric Young. Billy Lott at quarterback, sets them down now in the eye, takes out. Keats rolls to his right, pitch out on the corner for Lester Brown. Lester is hit after he gains a couple into the 39. Dave Wehmer got to him defensively that time. Lester needed that one block on the corner that time for a lot of yardage, but Wehmer was able to fend off a block and pull him down after a yard pickup. So it'll be second and 9.
Well, the fact remains that Notre Dame figures they're going to have to throw the ball to move it against the Tigers.
Eric Young goes split to the right side. Tuttle comes left with Joey Smith in the slot. Again, they line up in the eye with Sims and Brown in behind Billy Lott. This time the pitch is to Lester, and he's going to be thrown for minus yardage as he is nailed back around the 43-yard line by Bobby Leopold. Notre Dame's defense was there converging on Lester Brown as soon as he got the pitch. They have marked it at the 42-yard line where it becomes third down and 11 now.
But I heard somebody say a minute ago the corners were suspect. You might could move the ball against them there.
Not that time. They went to the short side of the field with it, and there was nothing. Tuttle comes left. Gilliard a slot left as Eric Young goes to the right side. Third down and long. In motion goes Gilliard to the right. Billy Lott is back to throw. Looking, firing deep. Down there, it's Eric Young, and it's incomplete inside the 5-yard line. Back covering Dave Durison and Tom Gibbons for Notre Dame. They had good double coverage on Young. And so the punting unit comes on once again as the Tigers are unable to take advantage of an opportunity. And David Sims will try to boom it out of there. Backed up deep, Dickerson and Durison. A high punt. They're going to let this one hit. It goes into the end zone. It'll come out to the 20. Notre Dame will take over at that point. First and 10 with 7:17 remaining here in the first quarter of play. Punt that time. 43 yards by David Sims. Notre Dame with the football at their own 20-yard line.
You know, Jim, a minute ago when the fullback carried the ball for Notre Dame was only the 44th time this year the fullback position has carried the football.
Hunter goes wide to the left side. Houlihan flanks to the right. High formation behind Rusty Leish at quarterback. He'll ride it off to Ferguson. Drives the left side. He gets running room. He's out over the 25, 30, out to the 32-yard line and knocked down there. Coming across defensively for the Tigers this time, Jack Kane. From his free safety position, Charlie Bauman was also down in there, but it's a first down for the Irish as they opened it up over the left side that time. Ball at their own 31-yard line. Hunter goes wide left. Houlihan flanks to the right. Again, they're in the eye. Rusty Leish at quarterback. Barks his signals. This time is riding it off. That's Ferguson sweeping wide to the left. Shakes a tackle. Gets out across the 40. Out to the 45 to the 46-yard line before he is finally pulled down. And the Tigers now doing a bit of arm tackling. And Ferguson running out of their grasp on the far side. Andy Hedden finally helps to pull him down over there. But it's another first down for the Irish as they've moved it now to the 46-yard line.
Well, he's everything that you've heard.
I tell you, you can't arm tackle him.
I'll check the stats on him in a minute again.
Hunter goes left, Houlihan right. First down, Notre Dame at their own 46. They line up in the eye. Rusty Leish again at quarterback. Takes out. This time, rides it off to the first back through. That's Ty Barber. A flag goes down as he cracks his way forward to the 47-yard line.
Harder's the ball carrier.
See what the indication is here. Illegal procedure against the Irish. So that'll cost them five. Stuckey and Bauman were there defensively for the Tigers that time.
Ferguson is number four in the nation in rushing right now, 127.8. Of course, White at Southern Cal has 178.8 to lead the nation.
Back to the 41 it goes. It's first down and 15 now for Notre Dame. Checking back in is John Sweeney at fullback. Brings a play with him to Rusty Leash. 6:19 remaining. First quarter action. No score here at Notre Dame Stadium as the Irish break from the huddle once again. Houlihan to the right side. Hunter goes left. Leash sets them down in the eye. Takes up. Back to throw. Looking deep down the left side. It is caught. That is Hunter. In at the Tiger 43-yard line where Rex Barn brings him down. There's the 6'5 Hunter, and Leash can really throw the ball to those big, tall receivers. That time, even though Rex had him well covered, there was no way that he could get in front and provide coverage from that side because he could never get to the football. Hunter was able to go up into the air and snare it, and it's a first down for Notre Dame at the Tiger 43-yard line.
That's their fourth first down.
Hunter goes left to the right side now. They bring Houlihan. Here's the ride off to the first man through. That's Carter. Got running room outside as he moves across the 35 and down to the 31-yard line. And Notre Dame now is moving the football against the Tiger defense like we haven't seen anyone move it in a long, long time. Jack Kane finally made that tackle. Another first down for the Irish.
Okay, that's where the real estate needs to get a little bit more expensive down here.
Houlihan goes to the left side. Leish brings them out in the eye. First and 10 at the Tiger, 31. Rides it off to Ferguson. Ferguson, a little tentative as he came up there, but seeking a hole, gets inside the 30, down near the 26-yard line before he stopped. Defensively, Bubba Brown was there for the Tigers.
Stopped by Goldberg and Brown.
A gain of five. It'll bring about second down and five now.
Tigers need the big defensive play now to slow this drive down. Notre Dame, of course, after what's happened to them, especially last week, really needs to get a good drive going and get a lead in a football game.
No potential wide receivers. They line up with three backs in the eye behind Leash. Now they bring in motion Houlihan, who comes to his right. The pitch is back to Ferguson. Ferguson slips outside and finally is caught, and he's knocked down around the 27-yard line. Jack Kane is there. David Reed is there. Ferguson comes up and a lot of times is hit, but bounces off tackles and sprints on outside. He did that time, but Reed was able to get to him along with Kane, and they bounce him down at the 26-yard line. So it'll be third down and just about 5 yards to go now for Notre Dame. This time they bring Houlihan to the right side. Leash sets them down with Ferguson at tailback, Sweeney at fullback. In motion comes Houlihan. Now he turns upfield. Ferguson running to the right. Knocked down as he gets to the 25-yard line. And it was Steve Durham who was fighting his way through with help from Jeff Davis and Charlie Bauman.
Not by Durham.
And Ferguson stopped as he gets into the 24-yard line, they'll mark it. So that will bring about fourth down and three. And Notre Dame bringing Chuck Mayo in now to attempt a field goal. It will be an effort of 42 yards, spotted at the hash mark right on the 32-yard line.
He had a real good early season. It's cooled off quite a bit, Mayo.
Cagle holding. As Mayo attempts the field goal, gets it up. It's got the distance, and it is good. So Mayo hits a 42-yard field goal, and with 3:19 remaining in the first quarter of play, there's timeout on the field with the score Notre Dame 3, Clemson nothing.
This is the Clemson Football Network.
Defco Auto Parts Stores.
Defco wants to help you get ready for winter with a Douglas, the Douglas battery, from a company that believes they have a product to fit your requirements. From a car to a riding lawnmower to the largest piece of off-the-road equipment, a Douglas is durable. You can depend on it despite the weather, and it's reasonably priced at your nearest DAPCO store.
And you can find a DAPCO store and easily at Imperial Products.
Mayo has put the Fighting Irish on the scoreboard first with a 42-yard field goal as capped an 80-yard drive. Mostly it was Ferguson on the ground, but a big pass to Hunt from Leash. It was a first down at the Tiger 43. Was one of the most important plays, a key play in that drive. Now the Tigers behind
Well, I'll tell you something. Notre Dame, very, very impressive on that drive. Even though they did not get into the end zone, they nonetheless were able to run and throw well against the Tigers. Mayo will kick off back deep for Clemson. Chuck McSwain to the near side. Andy heading to the far side. Everyone awaits now as Mayo approaches the football. Here's his high end-over-end kick. It's going to be Andy Hedden at the one. It went down. He fell down at the two-yard line. His feet went out from under him. And so the Tigers find themselves backed up now as they'll take over the football first and 10 at their own three-yard line. Andy's feet just flat went out from under him.
You don't make mistakes at South Bend unless you're willing to pay the price. And one of the mistakes the Tigers made was not capitalizing on a fumble when they had good field position.
All right, here we go. They'll work with a double tight end offense. They'll bring Perry Tuttle wide to the left side. Sims and Brown are in the eye behind Billy Lott at quarterback. Lott up under center, takes out. Gives off to Marvin Sims. He'll get out to the five-yard line, be stacked up there as a lot of green surrounds Marvin Sims after a couple of yards. Crable and Zedek are there defensively. So it'll be second down and 8 now as the ball is spotted at the five-yard line. 2 minutes, 58 seconds remaining. First quarter, Notre Dame on top, 3-0 over the Tigers.
Clemson has not been able to capitalize much on any wind advantage they might have had either.
Gilliard wide to the left side as Lott again sets them down in the eye. They try to get out of the shadow of their own goalpost with Marvin Sims, who's out to the 10. Down he goes at the 10-yard line. Good defensive job that time as Sitchy grabbed a hold of Marvin, and with the strength he has, it looked for a moment as if he may run away from Sitchy, but he hung in there, and down he went, just shy of the 10, where it is third down. They'll need 3 yards for a first down.
Tigers converted 1 out of 4 chances on third down so far.
Tuttle is going wide to the right side. Again, it's Sims and Lester Brown in behind Billy Lott. Third down. Lott barking out the signals. Pitch back to Lester Brown. Nowhere to go. Fights his way back to the line of scrimmage. And that's it as he came to his left. But Notre Dame was there, led by Bob Crable once again. And so David Sims will back up into the end zone now to punt.
Will the Irish rush or try to get a run back in good field position?
Dickerson to the near side, Durson to the far side. They're back at about their own 47-yard line as Sims is backed up 5 yards into the end zone. Snap back. Gets the kickoff. This is a low line drive kick. It's going to be grabbed off. Durson has it at the 48, gets across the 45 and into about the 41 or 2 yard line and is knocked down there. A punt of only 38 yards that time by David Sims as he squibbed that one off the side of his foot. So Notre Dame again with excellent field position as they'll have it in Tiger territory at the 42 yard line. A minute 25 remains in the first quarter with the Irish on top 3-0 in this game. $59,075 here this afternoon on a beautiful sunshiny afternoon. Houlihan is going to the left side. Hunter splits out right, and they'll have a wing to the right side, sending in motion Ferguson. Here's Leish back to throw over the middle, complete this one. That's to Hunter, and he's down inside the 20, down to the 15-yard line and out of bounds, and a flag goes down. We may have a late hit on the play. So Notre Dame threatening again as Hunter carries into the 15-yard line on that crossing pattern. The big 6'5 freshman grabbing the perfect pass from Leish.
Jim, is a word we use a lot, we announcers, and it's called momentum. And right now, it's wearing green.
They discuss, I believe, a late hit. This will bring with it a personal foul penalty. Well, it's going to go against Notre Dame. Let's see.
Have something, and Devine wants to know what, and I don't blame him.
Well, we'll have to see what it's all about down here.
Oh, it looked like almost a clip back here.
They're going to march it off against the Irish. From the point of infraction, which is the 15-yard line, it will bring it out to the 30-yard line now. Notre Dame charged with a personal foul. Must have been a hit after the whistle down there.
They don't move the chain stick, do they?
the Tiger 30-yard line. The Irish have the football now. Out they come, sending Houlihan wide to the left side. They'll bring Hunter split right. High formation behind Lish at quarterback. Lish takes out. Rides it off to Ferguson. Ferguson straight ahead, knocked down as he gets to the 29-yard line. Charlie Bauman was the first to get there and put the arms around him. And Jeff Davis and Bubba Brown came up to aid on the tackle, so it's spotted at the 29, a pickup of one. Second down, 24 to go for the Irish. Out they come once again with Houlihan to the left side and Hunter to the near side, split out. High formation behind Lish, dropping to throw, looking for Hunter all the way, fires incomplete at the 15-yard line. Hunter came open as he got in front of Gethers that time, but the pass was overthrown and goes incomplete. So now it'll be third down and 24 for the Irish.
Notre Dame pass protection has been excellent so far. Lish just stood back there and waited for his receiver to break open, just missed it. That's all.
42 seconds remaining in the first quarter of play. Houlihan goes wide to the left side. Hunter flanks to the near side. Again, the I formation behind Rusty Lish at quarterback. Lish looking to throw once more. Now firing over the middle. It is incomplete. Intended receiver was Hunter. And a good job defensively by Bubba Brown, who was with him step by step coming over the middle that time. And so Notre Dame now unable to move after the penalty set them back to the 30-yard line. We'll bring on Chuck Mayle again to attempt another field goal. This one will be an effort of 46 yards. He's already hit a 42-yarder from the right hash mark. And now we'll attempt a 46-yarder. We await the snap, the spot. The kick is up. The kick is no good as it goes wide to the left. And so the Tiger defense holds, and Clemson takes over the football at the 29-yard line. 33 seconds remaining in the first quarter of play here at Notre Dame Stadium. The Irish on top, 3-0. And the arm of Rusty Lish has moved Notre Dame well until they get down to about the 30-yard line. Then that Tiger defense has stopped them twice.
That time they look more like the Tiger defense that they have been all throughout the year.
Wide to the right side goes Tuttle. Eric Young splits off left end, and Gilliard becomes a slot on the right side now. Chuck McSwain's in at tailback for the Tigers. Billy Lott at quarterback, moving up under center. Tracy Perry also at fullback. Lott keeps, comes out over the 30, gets to the 33-yard line, and down he goes there, leading the way defensively, Bob Crable and John Hankard for Notre Dame. Spot the football just shy of the 34-yard line. That's a 5-yard pickup by Billy Lott, and it brings about second down and 5 for the Tigers. Joey Smith checking in now. We'll bring a play with him. Clock may run down here in the first quarter before they can get the playoff. It's showing 6 seconds at the moment as they break from the huddle. I don't believe they'll get a playoff. 2 seconds, 1 second, and there's the end of the first quarter. So here at Notre Dame Stadium in South Bend, Indiana, after one quarter of play, the score, Notre Dame 3, Clemson nothing.
Beer makes it good.
Every day, millions of times a day, America reaches for a Schlitz. And when you go for a Schlitz, go for the Tigers Bowl registration blank and win a trip for two to the Tigers Bowl. The Bowl Clemson or the ACC champion attend. Tiger Bowl registration blanks are available at your favorite Schlitz retailer with no purchase necessary. So go for one and go for a good cold Schlitz. You'll wonder why you ever went for anything else. Remember, Schlitz and the Tigers Bowl, they're worth going for.
Yeah, when it comes to beer.
Notre Dame leading by a score of 3-0 as we start the second period. They've been able to mix up their plays pretty well between the passing of Lish and the running of Ferguson. And their defense has just been something that the Tigers have been unable to figure out at all.
All right, out come the Tigers now. Second down 5 at their own 34-yard line. Tuttle is wide right. Joey Smith is in the slot right. Young goes to the left. Here's Lott handing it off, and straight ahead goes Tracy Perry, busts his way out to about the 38-yard line.
carries the ball carrier.
He'll be close to a first down, but I don't think he gets it. Scott Zedek was there along with Mark Zavagnin for Notre Dame. Just shy of a first down. It'll be third down at about a foot.
In the first quarter, Michigan leads Ohio State 7-3, Jim.
Wide to the right, Tuttle, Gilliard, a slot on the right side. Again, Young is split out left. Billy Lott up under center on third and less than a yard. This time rides it off to Tracy Perry, and he's got the first down as he's at the 39-yard line. 15 seconds here for station identification on the Clemson Football Network.
This is the Clemson Football Network.
Hi, everybody. Jim Phillips reminding you that I'll be around with Dan Kelly in the mornings, Keith Raines in the afternoons with all the latest in sports happenings. Join us on WFBC AM and FM, Greenville.
The Tigers got a first down. They have the football at their own 39-yard line. Now Tracy Perry motions to the sidelines. He wants to come out for some reason. I don't know whether it's an equipment repair or what. He called Marvin Sims in. So Sims is back in at fullback now. McSwain at tailback. Tuttle is wide right. Smith a slot on the right side. Eric Young splits out left. Oh, bad pitch. McSwain fields it on the hop, however. 40 out to the 45 to the 46-yard line. Billy Lott took a little punishment that time. Somebody sifted through there and really nailed him. Zavagnin and Gibbons were able to bring McSwain down, but he did an excellent job of fielding the pitch on the hop. Hankard was coming, and he's the one who got to Lott and forced the bad pitch.
McSwain kind of looked like Brooke Robinson getting a short hop.
Yeah, he did. Tuttle wide left this time. Gilliard in the slot. Eric Young splits off right end. High formation now behind Billy Lott, a quarterback. Marvin Sims and Chuck McSwain. This time it is McSwain once again. He's got some running room. He's over the 50 and into the 46-yard line of Notre Dame before he is pulled down. Big hole opened up over the left side behind Dolce and Nanny that time with Mark Clifford also and an injured Notre Dame player on the field at this moment. That is Sitchie, Steve Sitchie, the strong safety.
Gain of 8 yards.
Just into the second quarter of play. Irish on top, 3-0 over the Tigers.
You know, McSwain looks quicker the two times he's carried the ball here this afternoon than he had previously. To me, Jim, he really looks like he's coming to the ball.
Sitchie is holding that left arm as he comes to the sidelines. Tracy Perry has checked back in now for the Tigers. Marvin Sims trots back across the way. We're ready to go once again as Billy Lott moves into the Tiger huddle to call the play. 13 minutes and 19 seconds remaining in the first half. Notre Dame on top, 3-0 as Tuttle comes wide right. Gilliard a slot in motion, goes to the left side. Billy Lott, a quarterback, takes out, rolls to his right, looking to throw, now being chased, goes back to his left. Now he has some running room. Lott is into the 45 and down to the 43-yard line before he is pulled down. Getting to him was Dave Durison, the right cornerback. Billy that time was in trouble, so he turned back against the grain and was able to get about 3 yards.
He did a lot of running to pick up that 3 yards.
3 yard gain.
A lot better than being nailed back around the 50, though, where he was in real trouble.
He was going west to east a lot. He used to be going south.
Out they come. Young goes to the left side. Tuttle, wide right. Smith, a slot on the right side. Tracy Perry at fullback. Chuck McSwain, the tailback, as they work from the eye. This time it is Lott pitching out another bad pitch. McSwain fields it with one hand, though, and manages to get into the 39-yard line. Billy was off the mark somewhat on his pitches in the first half last week at North Carolina, and a couple of times here this afternoon has been off the mark, but thankfully, young Chuck McSwain has been able to do a good job. He might get a Golden Glove Award, as you indicated.
I was going to say, Bill Wilhelm might be want to look that guy up.
So mark it in just shy of the 39-yard line where it'll be 3rd and 4 for the Tigers. Set to go now. Here is Lott riding it off to Tracy Perry. A flag goes down. They'll stop this play. Probably some motion on behalf of the Tigers.
A flag on the play.
Take a look down here now. Yeah, it's going to cost the Tigers 5. It's going to bring about 3rd and closer to 9 yards now.
Jim, I'd like to point out also, unless in the last couple of plays when I looked away, Whittington has not gone back into the ball game for Notre Dame at linebacker after coming out earlier injured. He might be back in, but I just hadn't seen him on the sideline. That means 2 more men are not playing for them that had started the ball game on defense.
Ball is moved back out to the 44-yard line. Third down, the Tigers need nine now. Tuttle goes to the left side. Gilliard will be a slot left, and Eric Young is split off right end. Now in motion, that's Joey Smith rather than Gilliard. Here is Billy Lott, back to throw. Has time, now being flushed out of there, rolling to his right, looking downfield. Going to be caught for a loss back at the 49-yard line. Receivers were well covered downfield that time. Billy had time to set up but could find no one open, then was flushed out of the pocket. As he came to the sideline, he was still looking downfield, but no one made a breakaway, and he was unable to get rid of it, so he eats it back at the 49, and David Sims again will come in to do the putting.
Always better to eat the football than to throw it into the wrong area.
Gibbons and Wehmer back deep this time for the Irish as Sims hits one high into the wind. That one is going to hit at the 5 and bound on into the end zone. It'll come out to the 20-yard line, and Notre Dame will take over their first and 10 after a 49-yard punt by David Sims. So the Irish defensively stopping the Tigers here this afternoon. And, of course, the penalty is hurting the Tigers as well. Little mistakes that have occurred throughout the season. Seems as though this club continues to be destined to be a second-half offensive team, Ken.
You know, Jim, when two teams matched up like this are playing, you can't afford the mistake.
Sweeney and Ferguson will be in the eye behind Rusty Lation, quarterback. Hunter goes wide to the right side. Houlihan is in motion right. Pitch back. Ferguson sweeping to his left. Down he goes at the 20-yard line. Got nowhere as Jeff Davis led the charge of Tiger defenders. Stuckey and Bauman were also there. So no gain on the play. It'll bring about second and 10 for Notre Dame.
And it's a great misdirection. They moved a slot man or a flanker man away from that, taking a Tiger defensive back to the other side of the field, and they came back to the short side with the play.
Hunter comes to the left. Houlihan goes out wide to the right side. Again, they work from the eye behind Rusty Leisha, quarterback. Leisha takes out, gives to Ferguson once more. He finds running room. He's out over the 25, 30, out to the 32-yard line. Finally knocked down by Hollis Hall. A trap play, and it was open for Ferguson to scamper for a first down. So mark the football at the 32-yard line of the Irish. They have it first and 10.
What a fine running back Ferguson is.
Hunter comes to the left side. Houlihan goes right. Leish may be looking to throw on first down here. He drops. Looking over the middle. Now firing deep. This is intended for Hunter. Can't quite get to it. Down at the Tiger 28 and pass interference. Going to be called against Hollis Hall. No question about it. Hollis had a hand on him as they went down the sideline. And that's a big first down for Notre Dame in at the Tiger 30-yard line.
Another mistake.
Hunter had him beat. And Hollis was reaching out. And though the pass was overthrown, it's just as good as being complete because the Irish have it first and 10 into the Tiger 30.
Now we're going back the other way.
Well, what's going on here?
I've lost something. Is there a flag back down there?
There is. I didn't see it. We've got the interference going against the Irish back here. With offsetting penalties. Both sides were guilty of pass interference on a play away from the ball. Evidently, one of the Irish offensive players was pushing off. Dan Devine walks out onto the field. He questions the call.
Loss of down, too, I think they're calling.
Loss of down, right, because it's offsetting penalties, and it's just a play that's gone into the books. And the next one comes up.
Well, I've got to take away a first down for Notre Dame that I'd already given him on the chart.
Well, it's
here.
Back to the 17-yard line now. Houlihan goes to the right. Hunter comes to the left. Leish has them in the eye. Up under center now on a long count. Takes out, rides it off, and sweeping wide to the right is Carter. Carter gets some running room. He's out over the 30 to the 31-yard line. Finally to the 32 and knocked down there, where it now will be third down and 10 for Notre Dame. Kennard. Terry Kennard made the defensive play for the Tigers. So now it is third down and 10 for Notre Dame at their own 32-yard line. Back in goes Sweeney at fullback. Imagine Lish will be throwing to one of those big, tall receivers, Ken.
I would think so, yes.
Hunter comes left. Houlihan goes to the right. Leach has a wing on the left side. That's Ferguson. Now he's back to throw. Looking deep. Firing. It is complete. Out at the 50. It into Tiger territory. That's Houlihan at the 47-yard line before he is pulled down. Pete Houlihan. Again, a big target along that sideline, and Leach just had all the time in the world to set up and seek out his receiver as Eddie Gethers brought him down, but it's a Notre Dame first down at the Tiger 47-yard line.
That's their seventh first down.
Houlihan comes left. Hunter goes to the right side. High formation behind quarterback Rusty Leach. This time he rides it off to the first man through. That is Carter. Carter fights his way into the 40-yard line before he is pulled down. Willie Underwood was there defensively. But Notre Dame doing a good job opening holes in that Tiger defensive front. Their running backs have had the hole at the line of scrimmage and have been running in the broken field on many occasions here this afternoon.
Makes me wonder why they haven't been running the fullback any more than they have this year, Jim.
Out they come again. Hunter goes wide right. Houlihan splits out left. Leach quarterback sets them down in the eye. Notre Dame at the Tiger 40-yard line. Second down and three. Out it comes. Ferguson gets the call, sweeps wide to his right at the 35. He's at the 30. Down the sidelines and pulled down at the 25-yard line. Terry Kennard finally got to him. But Ferguson got good blocking on the short side of the field and was able to carry for a first down to the Tiger 25-yard line.
You know, he kind of intimidates you when he runs. You put a hand on him, but he just kind of goes away from you.
Clock shows 8.5 minutes remaining in the first half with the Irish leading 3-0, but they're threatening again. Hunter goes to the right. Houlihan comes left. They work from the eye with Carter and Ferguson. This time it is Carter. He slides outside left tackle, and Willie Underwood finally hauls him down as he gets into about the 23. Also, Jeff Davis defensively for the Tigers.
You know, ball control team like the Tigers get down by 10 can be very, very bad, even with this much time left of the ball game. Trying to play catch-up.
All right, it's at the 23-yard line. Houlihan to the right, Hunter to the near side. Sweeney is back in at fullback now. He and Ferguson in the eye. Rusty Leach, quarterback, gives to Vegas Ferguson. Finds a hole over the 20, 15, and down to about the 13-yard line where he's bounced out of bounds. And it was Terry Kennard who finally horsed him out of bounds. But another first down for the Irish as they're in at the Tiger 13-yard line. And listen to this partisan Irish crowd now. They are really opening some gaping holes at the line of scrimmage. They're whipping the Tigers up front. Houlihan will be a wing to the left side. They'll work from a split backfield this time. And now we have a timeout. The Tigers want to talk it over defensively as they have asked for a timeout. So with 7:43 remaining in the half, timeout on the field, the score, Notre Dame 3, Clemson nothing.
This is the Clemson Football Network. Now at Jack Barry Chrysler Plymouth, you can buy any 1980 in stock, including Horizon, TC3, Arrow, and Arrow Truck at just 5% over factory invoice. Plus, you'll get a $300 check from Chrysler if you buy any new 1979 or 80 Volare, Cordoba, New Yorker, Newport, Grand Fury, Voyager, Trail Duster, or Lebanon. You'll agree that Jack Barry Chrysler Plymouth offers the highest quality, excellent mileage, and the best service, all at the lowest prices. And only from Jack Barry Chrysler Plymouth, 523 West Washington Street in Greenville.
A 3-0 football game. Notre Dame out front, threatening once more down at the Tiger 13-yard line. And this time, once more, it's been mixing up the plays. It's been the running of Ferguson, although Carter got off a run that did hurt the Tigers, and the passing of Leach. And they've really attacked all areas at Clemson. Boy, from corner to the middle to over them.
All right, out they come. They'll bring Houlihan out as the wing to the left side. They'll work with Sweeney and Ferguson in a split backfield behind Leach. This time the ride is off to Ferguson, sweeping wide to his left. Out of bounds he goes at the 11-yard line as Bubba Brown and Terry Kennard are there to chase him down. So he picks up two, and it'll bring about second down and 8 now for Notre Dame. As they mark the football at the 11-yard line, Carter is getting back in. Sweeney checks out.
You've got a second guess, maybe a pass here, Jim?
Might look for one of those big, tall receivers, but none of them out wide. They're in a double tight end offense. High formation behind Leach. Now he sends Houlihan in motion. Pitch back to Ferguson, sweeping to his left, and he's out over the 10 into about the 7-yard line before he goes down. Kennard was there to cover him, but he was actually upended at the line of scrimmage by David Reed and fell forward. So mark it at the 7 now, where it's 3rd down, 4 yards to go for Notre Dame.
Okay, they've converted, believe it or not, only 1 out of 3. As far as 3rd down to conversions are concerned, a big long drive they had. They didn't run, they were getting 1st downs on 2nd down.
Ty Barber is checked in now. They'll run with 3 backs behind the quarterback, likely send Houlihan in motion. He is the one immediately behind Leishman. He comes in motion, left side. The ride is off to the fullback. That is Barber, and I believe he's got a 1st down. He's in at the 2-yard line. Good surge off the... Wait a minute. Is he shy? Apparently, he's going to be a little shy. It's not quite up to the 3-yard line.
Bubba Brown thinks he's shy anyway.
Well, they're going to bring it in and take a measure now. Here comes the chain stick gang from across the field.
That was a big play for both ball teams. There's a lot of difference.
He doesn't have the 1st down. They're about a foot shy.
They got to decide right here.
So do they go for it or do they go for 3? They're going to go for a 1st down or 6. John Sweeney is checked back in at fullback. Brings with him a play from the sideline. Tiger defense has not been able to stop the running game thus far. And they'll see what they can do now. Houlihan has a wing to the right side. Rusty Leish keeps. I think he's got it. He's in near the 2-yard line, and that should be enough for a 1st down. On a quarterback sneak, Leish straight ahead. And I believe his forward progress would give him the 1st down without question.
If so, that'll be their 10th.
Now they're going to measure. It's 1st down, though, because the chain stick is on the 3 and the ball is in at the 2.5. So I would guess that the Tigers probably asked for this measurement. It was pretty obvious that it is a 1st down. By more than a length of the football. So it is 1st and goal, Notre Dame. The ball spotted just outside the 2-yard line of the Tigers. And the Irish leading 3-0, trying to put more points on the board now as Sweeney and Ferguson will be the running backs. Rusty Leish will bring Houlihan out as a wing to the right side. Leish takes out, rides it off to Ferguson, tries to get in there, and is met right about the 2, and down he goes there as the Tigers stacked it up well that time on the left side. Bryant, Jeff Bryant, big defensive tackle, was up in front, sophomore out of Atlanta. Charlie Bauman was in there.
They've run 14 plays of this drive so far that started back at their own 20-yard line.
2nd down and goal, ball in at the 2-yard line. They'll come out once again in the eye. The ride goes off this time. The Ferguson touchdown. Vegas Ferguson from 2 yards away behind a good surge by the offensive line, and Notre Dame's on top 9-0 over the Tigers now as we have the try for the point after coming up. And Chuck Mayo will come on now to attempt to make it a 10-0 football game with 5:53 remaining in the 1st half of play here at South Bend, Indiana. The Irish of Notre Dame. All right, here's the try for the point after now as we await the snap. Here's the spot. Mayo's kick is up. He's
looking at this Notre Dame offense.
All right, the Tigers have been whipped up front. First time I've seen anyone go at them the way Notre Dame has here this afternoon, this season. They have really bounced the Tigers around at the line of scrimmage. So McSwain and Hedden backed up now. We'll see if they can't get some good field position. And Billy Lott and company will come on to see if they can't get something going. Chuck Mayo to kick off. Ball fell off the tee, so he'll back up and retrace his steps. They just took Sitchie down into the locker room, still holding that left arm. Now Mayo has a place back on the tee to his satisfaction. And again, the wind blows it off. Up here in the Midwest, there's nothing but flat land as far as the eye can see, and a lot of wind.
Right now, it's an ill win for the Tigers, too, as it's doing them no good.
Well, they're moving against it here in this second quarter of play. But that's not been their problem. Here's Mayo's kick, a squibber that's going to hit and bound on into the end zone. It will be touchdown, and it'll come out to the 20 after the touchback, and the Tigers will start at the 20-yard line now, first and 10.
Okay, this is where Notre Dame started their last two scoring drives, both of them at the 20-yard line after Sims punt.
Well, the offense has had a long time over there on the sideline now to discuss their situation. And let's see what they do with the football now. Out they come. Tuttle goes wide to the left side. Gilliard will slot left. Eric Young will split to the right. Marvin Sims in at fullback. As they work from the eye now, Billy Lott up under center. This time keeping. Turning upfield, crosses the 25. Lott gets out to the 30-yard line before he is knocked down. Billy's going to be close to if he does not have a first down. He'll be awfully close to it. Zedek and Kramer were there defensively for Notre Dame.
You know, Jim, the Tigers, yeah, that's the first down.
Yeah, he crossed the 30 with it, so it is a first down for Clemson now at their own 30-yard line.
They're going to, the Tigers going to have some sort of offense through the air to get the ground game going again.
Tuttle goes wide left. Joey Smith will slot to the left side as Young splits off right end. High formation. Lester Brown at tailback. Marvin Sims at fullback. Billy Lott takes out, gives to Sims. The big fullback pounds his way forward to the 35-yard line.
Sims, the ball carrier.
Tripped up there. Kramer got a hand on him and bowled him down. So it is now second down and five. Gilliard checks back in with a play. Clock is down to 5 minutes and 5 seconds remaining in the second quarter. 10-0 Notre Dame on top. Eric Young wide to the right. Tuttle goes left. Gilliard in the slot left. Lott at quarterback. Takes out. This time, Lester Brown. Lester really nailed as he gets out to the 37-yard line. Good job defensively that time by Notre Dame as Lester was quick off the football, but Crable was quick to react and get to him.
Notre Dame line just looked so strong. Just physically strong, each individual football player out there, aside from being big.
Third down and three for the Tigers now. Eric Young goes left. Tuttle comes right with Smith inside him as a slot. Big third down play for the Tigers. Billy Lott sets them in the eye, takes out. This time is keeping, has the first down at the 45 midfield. Lott, if he had kept going to the sidelines, may have picked up some additional yardage, but he leaned back inside and does, however, carry all the way down to the 41-yard line of Notre Dame. So Billy got him on a little misdirect that time, got them flowing the opposite way defensively, and is able to get a first down at the Irish 41. 4 minutes, 10 seconds remaining in the first half of play. Eric Young goes wide left. Tuttle comes out right. Gilliard a slot to the right side. Lott up under center with Sims and Brown set in behind. This time, looking to throw, fires. It's for Tuttle, and he's got it. Carries down to the 25-yard line. A quick look in that time, and Tuttle broke into the clear, got away from Gibbons, the defender, and it's another first down, Tigers, as they have put together their best-looking drive of the afternoon into the Irish 25-yard line.
The angle Tuttle had not he been hit just what he was, he could have been off to the races, too.
Well, he was popped pretty good. He's not injured, I don't think. He just went along the sidelines. Fred Hoover taking a look at him there, but pats him on the back. That's an indication he's okay. Kendall Alley has moved in flanker to the left side now. Smith is a slot left. Billy Lott rides it out to Marvin Sims, looking for some running room. Gets a couple as he moves into about the 23, maybe the 22-yard line, and is hit there by Pat Kramer. Marvin is just a good, strong, straight-ahead runner, and that time he had to do a little dancing out there and step outside of a couple of tackles. He was able to get into the 23-yard line, where it is second down and eight now for the Tigers, trailing 10-0 in the football game with 3:10 remaining in the first half. Tuttle wide left, Gilliard slot left. Eric Young splits off the right end. Billy Lott has them down in the eye, takes out. This time, pitching off on the corner, behind Lesser a little bit, and he had to slow down to get it, and is stopped back at the 25-yard line, so Billy continues to be errant in his pitches.
Kind of looks like he might not be reading his keys well enough and waiting too late to pitch out, like he is slow making up his mind as to whether or not he's going to keep it or whether or not he is going to pitch it.
It was Crable who got to Lester Brown that time. The ball is backed up to the 25, where it'll be third down and 10 now for the Tigers.
What if anybody thinks they're going to pass here?
Eric Young goes to the left. Joey Smith will be inside of Perry Tuttle, wide right. I formation again behind Billy Lott at quarterback. Smith in motion. Billy back to throw. Being chased. Rolling right. Caught. Knocked down back at the 39-yard line, and that'll take him out of field goal range. The secondary of Notre Dame doing a good job on coverage. Zavagnin and Hankert get to Billy Lott all the way back at the 38-yard line. And that takes them out of field goal range, and they have to bring David Sims on again. Notre Dame thought they were going to pass. They had a good rush. Does that answer your question, Ken?
Yeah, certainly did.
So Sims back to punt now. Gets the snap. Oh, he hit a squibber. Going to go out of bounds at the 20-yard line. That's one of the worst punts that David has had all year. He was looking to that coffin corner on the right side, and he squibbed it. So that's a punt of only about 18 yards.
You know, the Tigers have played, except for the first 3 or 4 minutes of the ballgame, have played poorly, basically, on offense. If they can survive here and the defense can save them and keep them at 10, maybe they can regroup at halftime.
Well, there's a minute 39 remaining in the first half. A lot of time on the clock for this offense of Notre Dame that has looked very, very good this afternoon. Out come the Irish. Houlihan will go to the right side. They'll bring Hunter to the left side. Split backfield now behind Lish. Rusty takes out. He's looking to throw. And firing. It is Hunter. Incomplete out at the 44-yard line. He threw it over Hunter that time, and that's not an easy thing to do because he's 6'5", very rangy. Rex Varn and Kennard were back on coverage for the Tigers. So it'll be second down and 10 for Notre Dame now at the 24-yard line. Minute 34 showing on the clock. Houlihan sprints out wide to the right side. They'll work from an eye behind Lish at quarterback. Rusty Lish riding it off to Ferguson. Big hole. That's not Ferguson. Check that. It's Jim Stone in a tailback now, and he's got a first down as he crouched to the 35 or 36-yard line. Rex Varn brought him down there. So a first down for the Irish as they've spotted it now at the Notre Dame 36-yard line.
Jim, the Tigers at that time looked like they had 3 down linemen. They've been switching some defenses around a little bit, trying to find some way to stop this Notre Dame offense.
Houlihan goes to the right side. Hunter comes left. Lish is back to throw. Looking, firing deep, intended for Hunter. It is caught. And down the sidelines, out of bounds at the 30-yard line. Rex Varn was in pursuit, but a beautifully thrown football, and Hunter was out behind, grabbed it, and then stepped out of bounds. And let's see at what point he went out of bounds. They're going to mark it in at about the 26-yard line. Boy, he's got some fine receivers to throw to, and Mr. Lish can throw a football. It's at the 26 of the Tigers, first and 10, Notre Dame. Wide to the right side goes Houlihan. Hunter splits off left end. Lish has Carter and Ferguson in the eye now. Takes out. Vegas Ferguson sweeping wide to his left. Gets to the 20, down to the 15, and finally out of bounds at the 10-yard line. Vegas Ferguson dancing his way, got to the sidelines, and carries to the 10. Another first down. Goldberg and Underwood chased him out of bounds there. Our halftime talk show, the number to call, 803-271-9322. 803-271-9322 for our halftime talk show. And we'll welcome your questions here. As the Irish leading 10-0, threatening to make it even more now with a minute 4 remaining in the half. Houlihan goes wide to the right side. Hunter splits off left end. Lish is back to throw. He's looking for Houlihan. Now he's going to run with it. The flag goes down. We may get holding at the point the flag was thrown. Lish made it to the end zone, but there was a flag. And I believe we may get holding here.
You know, Jim, if so, that would be the third major expensive penalty against Notre Dame here this afternoon.
It is holding, and it is against the Irish. When you see a flag thrown there when a man is out of containment, rolling out of the pocket, You can almost guess what the call is going to be, and that time the Irish were detected holding.
The only time there's been any pressure on Lish whatsoever from the Tigers' defensive line.
So it moves it back out to the 25-yard line now.
Final score, Miami of Ohio 27, Cincinnati 14.
First down. And 25 yards to go for Notre Dame.
They've absolutely controlled the line of scrimmage, as we have both said.
Houlihan goes wide to the right side. Hunter splits off left. They'll work from a split backfield now with Carter and Stone. Back to throw is Lish. He's looking, firing, and complete into the 22-yard line to Jim Stone coming out. Whoops, they rule it incomplete. Did not hang on to the football. An incomplete pass. So it'll come back out to the 25.
You know, so far, none of the close calls have gone for the Irish, Jim. All the close ones have gone for the Tigers. And the officials' judgment, the decisions they've had to make.
Well, unfortunately, though, the Notre Dame team has just outplayed the Tigers thus far in this game. It has built up a 10-0 lead, and they threaten again with 52 seconds left in the half. Houlihan to the right, Hunter to the left. Sweeney and Stone in the eye behind Lish. Rusty back to throw. He's looking, firing. It is caught and down inside the 20 to about the 17-yard line.
Lish to Mastak.
Mastak, the tight end, the receiver. And they will mark it at the 16-yard line. And it will be third down and about 15 yards to go for Notre Dame. From there, as we have a timeout on the field. So with timeout, the score, Irish 10, Tigers nothing.
This is the Clemson Football Network.
When's the last time you saw a car stalled at the side of the road with the hood up and the steam pouring into the sky? Well, the winter months are hard on your car's cooling system. DAPCO wants to remind you to have your car's cooling system checked before the cold weather sets in. And when you do, ask for Gates Quality Cooling System products. You'll find them at your DAPCO store.
And you can find a DAPCO store in Woodruff at Ron's Auto Parts.
Seconds to go in the half. 10-0 the score. Notre Dame has completely dominated the football game over the Tigers here this afternoon. They've done it at the line of scrimmage. They've done it with their defense and with their offense. And right now, Lish has been over talking to his offensive coaches. He's back in on this big third down play.
Houlihan will go to the right. Hunter will come to the left. They'll work with a split backfield as Rusty Lish moves up under center. He has Sweeney and Stone behind him. Third down, 15 yards to go for Notre Dame. Lish back to throw, looking, firing a quick out. Good job by Hollis Hall, who deflected the pass that was intended for Hunter. And Hollis, playing in front that time, was able to deflect it away and out of bounds. And so Notre Dame now will call on Chuck Mayo once again to attempt a field goal. Line of scrimmage, the 16 of the Tigers at the left hash mark. Mayo will kick from the 23. It will be a 33-yard effort. So we await the snap. Here's the spot. Mayo's kick is up. It's got the distance. It is no good. Wide to the right. Mayo misses from 33 yards. And so the Tigers will get the football at their own 20-yard line with 34 seconds remaining in the half. Well, that is without question a big break there, Ken.
Well, he had had his problems recently in his field goal kicking. He was doing so well earlier in the year, but Mayo has run into some problems. And as you said, that is tremendous. That and the penalty that set him
back.
That's
it, the penalty right there. The holding penalty was the costly one for Notre Dame that time. Eric Young goes wide left. Tuttle is split to the right with Gilliard a slot to the right side. Now Billy Lott just going to lay down on the football at the 19-yard line. Let that clock run down. The Tigers want to get to the locker room. They want to discuss some strategy. They'll have the football to start the third quarter. They will need points because they are trailing at this time 10-0. And now Notre Dame stops the clock with a timeout. And with timeout on the field, 23 seconds remaining in the half, the score, Notre Dame 10, Clemson nothing.
This is the Clemson Football Network.
At the Tire Exchange, they're doing something about the rising cost of gasoline. The Tire Exchange recommends that all of their customers buy a set of Michelin X steel-belted radials. Now, whether you drive an American car, an import, light truck, or RV, riding on Michelin radials can save you gas when compared to bias-ply tires. And the Tire Exchange has affordable prices on Michelins, so you can save money.
stop by the Tire Exchange, 205 North Pleasantburg Drive in Greenville. Also locations in Greer, Malden, and Simpsonville.
The Tigers just want to regroup.
All right, they come out. Three wideouts. Billy Lott at quarterback. Brock will start when he takes the snap. He rides it off. First man through is Marvin Sims. He'll carry out to the 25-yard line where he's pulled down by Bob Crable. Clock continuing to run now down to 13 seconds. And again, Notre Dame stops it as they got a timeout. So obviously, the Tigers need a first down here in order to get the clock to run down. 13 seconds remaining on that clock. Our halftime talk show this afternoon, 271-9322, the number to call, 803, the area code. And if you're calling from outside the Greenville, South Carolina area, you can call collect. Right now, the Tigers needing a first down to keep Notre Dame from getting their hands on the football once again here in the first half. As the Irish have built up a 10-0 lead, and the Tigers quite fortunate in that they're only trailing by 10. Because Notre Dame has had a couple of other drives that fell dry by missed field goals. So now Billy Lott takes out, rides off to Marvin Sims. He'll carry it out to the 28-yard line, and down he goes there. They do not get the yardage for the first down. 5 seconds remaining in the half. Notre Dame is out of timeouts. The clock will run down. And we have reached the end of the first half of play here at Notre Dame Stadium in South Bend, Indiana. At halftime, the score, the Irish 10, the Tigers nothing.
Pause 15 seconds for station identification on the Clemson Tiger Football Network.
This is the Clemson Football Network.
Hi, everybody. Jim Phillips reminding you that I'll be around with Dan Kelly in the mornings, Keith Raines in the afternoons with all the latest in sports happenings. Join us on WFBC AM and FM, Greenville.
Ferguson has carried the ball, by the way, 17 times for 94 yards here this afternoon and a touchdown. His longest run was 15 yards. Carter has carried the ball 6 times for 44 yards. And the fullbacks for Notre Dame had only carried the ball 43 times the entire season coming into this ball game, according to the figures that we had. Marvin Sims has carried it 10 times for the Tigers, picked up 42 yards. Billy Lott, 7 for 20 yards. That's his net in a 22-yard run. McSwain, 3 for 18. And Lester Brown, 7 for only 6 yards. That's hard to believe. Tuttle caught the only pass for the Tigers. That was a 16-yard pass. Hunter has had 2 for 54. Hollahan had 2 for 49. As we told you, David Sims has had trouble punting the ball this afternoon. Only 38.2. Now, he did get off a 49-yarder, but he got off the shortest of his career. Some 20-something yards also earlier. And Notre Dame's only punted once, and that's for 29 yards. Both teams back out, getting very close to time to get this football game back underway. The Tigers do get the football. It'll be Notre Dame's time to kick. So this is going to be very important. Remember, the Tigers have given up only one touchdown in the third period throughout the year. They had outscored their opponents something like 54-7 in the third period. So maybe Tiger fans down through there can find something to cheer about as this third period goes along, Jim.
Well, there's a big one being played in Ann Arbor this afternoon, and Michigan is leading Ohio State 15-12 after three quarters of play now. Right here, however, it is the Irish and the Tigers. McSwain and Andy Hedden are backed up deep. And ready to do the kicking off will be Chuck Mayo for Notre Dame as we move to this third quarter action now. And let's see if the Tigers can establish something in the way of momentum and get some points on the board here in the second half.
An interesting thing, Jim. The Notre Dame Fighting Irish have made more actual mistakes than the Tigers have this afternoon. More penalties. They've lost the football on a fumble. The Tigers haven't lost a fumble yet. And yet they have controlled the football game.
Well, as I said earlier, and I believe this, the Tigers are very fortunate that they weren't down 21-0 at this point. They could well have been.
Absolutely.
But let's see what develops now as Mayo is set to kick off to McSwain and Hedden, who have backed up to the goal line for the Tigers. Notre Dame kicking from the south end of the field with the wind behind them. A high, high kick very deep into the end zone. McSwain will grab it and fall on it, touch it down 8 yards deep in the end zone. And the Tigers now will bring it out to the 20 where they'll get the football first and 10. First offensive series here in the second half of play. 10-0, Notre Dame on top in this football game. Billy Lott at quarterback. Brings them out with Marvin Sims and Lester Brown as the running backs. Sends Perry Tuttle wide to the right side as they work with a twin tight end offense now. Lott on first down, moves up under center. Takes out, this time is keeping, running, and thrown for a loss. Back at the 18-yard line, it was John Hankard, the defensive end, who was right with him all the way and hauls him down from behind. So a loss of two, it's now second down and 12 for the Tigers.
Notre Dame that time lined up in an actual, looked like a normal five front for the first time, I think, this afternoon that I had seen it. They've been in a four and a three front. This time they had five down linemen.
Gilliard goes wide to the left side. Again, they'll work with double tight ends. Billy Lott at quarterback on second down and 12 from his own 18. Back to throw, looking, firing quickly over the middle for Mark Clifford. Big catch out at the 41-yard line. Clifford, the tight end, with a big grab at the 41 for a first down. Tom Desiato was there to make the tackle.
He was as wide open as he's ever going to be, that's for sure.
Well, he ran a good pattern, and Billy threw the ball just a little high, but Clifford, leaving his feet, was able to gather it in and get the first down. Tuttle comes wide to the right side. Sims and Brown line up in the eye behind Billy Lott at quarterback. Lott now on a long count, takes out. This time, gives off to Marvin. He bowls straight ahead and crosses the 45-yard line before he is knocked down. Marvin Sims appeared to be down back around the 43-yard line, but he brushed off, and Dulcey with a good block that time on the left side got Marvin a good strong 5 yards.
First time Tigers had the ball, they moved it a little bit on Notre Dame, then seemed to have lost some intensity.
So Wagner and Durison were there defensively that time for Notre Dame. This time it's Gilliard wide to the right side. Second down and five Tigers at their own 46-yard line. Lott takes out. Pitch back. Here's Lester Brown sweeping to his left. Nowhere to go. He's thrown down at the 45. Zedek was there defensively. And Lester just had nowhere to run with the football that time. So now it will be third down and just a little better than 5 yards for a first down. So this is a big third down play now for the Tigers. They're trailing 10-0 in the football game. Notre Dame has dominated throughout the first 30 minutes of play. Tuttle is wide to the right side. Lott is back to throw, rolling to his right. Now being chased from behind, and down he goes at his own 40-yard line. Getting to him was Joe Gramke, the defensive right end. Again, Billy found his receivers covered, and as he was flushed out of the pocket, Gramke was coming up from behind and nails him, and David Sims will have to punt the football. Dickerson and Durison drop back as the twin receivers for Notre Dame. Sims standing back at his 26, awaiting the snap, has it. Gets the kick away, and he has hit one beautifully. Dickerson backed up, gathers it in at his 20, fumbles it, and the Tigers have got the football, I believe. Down around the 20, it is Clemson football. Five-yard punt, and the ball fumbled. And the Tigers get it back as falling on it was Charlie Langford. Check that. Chuck Rose. I beg your pardon. Chuck Rose fell on the football. It's at the 21-yard line of Notre Dame, Clemson football.
Okay, there's a gift. They have got to make something out of right now, Jim.
Wide to the right side comes Tuttle. Yep, you're right, Ken. They have got to take advantage of this one. Lott sets them down with Sims. And Lester behind. Ride to Marvin Sims. 10 down to the 7-yard line goes Marvin Sims. A big hole over the left side that time behind Nanny and Dulcey. And Marvin Sims breaking down to the 7-yard line where it'll be first and goal for the Tigers now.
Okay, you're in close. And that's a long way. That's first and goal from 7 yards out.
Well, I'll tell you, they opened it up that time for Marvin, though, and he hit the hole and splashed on through. Wide to the right side, Gilliard. Billy Lott at controls at quarterback. Up under center he goes. Takes off. Lester Brown straight ahead to the 5, down to the 3-yard line before he is pulled down. Marvin Sims was leading the way that time, and Lester right in behind him gets it into the 3 where it's second down and goal.
That drops the ball carrier.
Okay. The rubber duck himself is one of those guys that a friend of ours likes to call a money ball player, where the going gets down where it really counts down in there.
Out they come, double tight ends, power eye formation. Chuck McCall in as the strength to the right side. Billy Lott keeping. Ball is stripped from him, and who's got it? I think he fell back on it at the four-yard line. A Notre Dame defender stripped the ball away, but Billy was able to follow on it at the four, and now it is third down and goal for the Tigers. That time he tried that rollout that worked successfully last week, but Notre Dame was more than ready for it. They had a look at those films. So now the Tigers face with a third and goal at the four. Power eye, strength to the left side. Billy Lott at quarterback. Rolling, left, looking to throw. Incomplete, overthrew his intended receiver, Mark Clifford, his tight end. Meanwhile, McCall was, I think, wide open near the corner of the end zone, and Billy didn't see him.
Mark, this is no great tragedy. If the field goal attempt by Arriri is good, Jim, it is not a great tragedy. You were going to have at least that anyway.
That's right. You got to have points on the board, and right now you've got to try and get the three. Bo Blanton to hold. Arriri will attempt a field goal of 20 yards directly in front of the goalpost. The spot, the kick is up. The kick is good. So there was time out of the field with 10:49 remaining in the third quarter. The score, Notre Dame 10, the Tigers 3.
This is the Clemson Football Network. Shop Winn-Dixie for great food values, including WD brand UF government grade A broad-breasted turkeys, 10 pounds and up, unbasted 69 cents a pound, and ready-basted 79 cents a pound. Swift's Hostess round canned hams, the 4-pound size, $7.99, limit 2. Country Fresh all-natural prestige ice cream, the half gallon, $1.89. And Dixie Crystal box sugar, 3 boxes for $1, limit 3 with a $7.50 or more order at your neighborhood Winn-Dixie food store.
Tigers turned a Notre Dame fumble off a David Sims punt into a 20-yard field goal by Ovid Arriri. So they're on the scoreboard right now. And that should do something psychologically. And also, you've got to, if you're the Notre Dame people, you've got to say, we're still making these mistakes. And that was a bad, bad mistake to make as far as they're concerned. And this time, the Tigers were able to make something out of it.
Well, let's see if the defense can come out now and play with the enthusiasm they've shown in weeks past. Arriri will be kicking. Stone will be deep down the far side. Barber on the near side. Obit will be kicking into a pretty stiff wind here. It's a crosswind, but it blows mostly out of the southwest. And he's kicking into it now. There's a swibber that's going to go out of bounds at about the 18 or 19-yard line, and I'm sure Notre Dame would elect to have him kick from the 35. So Obit, who missed it, shows a little disgust as he picks up the tee and retreats back toward the 35-yard line to re-spot the ball and kick off again.
You know, Jim, nobody has any answers when a football team is not playing to what you think is their potential, as the Tigers did in the first half of this football game. The only thing you can say is the defense looked like they were lacking concentration out there.
Well, there were a lot of times when it looked like they were arm tackling.
Yeah.
Which is something you obviously can't do when you're up against good running backs. Ball is at the 35 now, and Ovid Arriri has it placed on the tee again, approaches it. Here's his kick. This time he hits it high, end over end. It's going to be grabbed off by Stone at the 13, out across the 15, 20, and down he goes as he crosses the 23 to about the 24-yard line. And leading the way down there defensively for the Tigers, Andy Heddens up out of that stack, along with several others there. They got to the sideline too quickly.
Okay.
So it's spotted at the 24-yard line, or check that, the 29-yard line, where Notre Dame has it first and 10. 10-3, they lead in the game. Sweeney and Ferguson in the eye behind Rusty Leish as he sends Hunter wide to the right side. Brings Houlihan in motion from right to left. Gives off to Vegas Ferguson. He sweeps outside right tackle, has running room, crosses the 35 and out to the 39-yard line where he is knocked down. Jerry Kennard and Willie Underwood make the tackle, but Ferguson picking up where he left off in the first half. That now puts him over 100 yards as he picks up 9 yards on the play.
No great secret to that play, I don't think. It's just one of those...
Good job up front blocking.
Yeah.
Good cut by Ferguson.
All he has to do is find the hole and go through it, and he's quick enough to go through a little hole.
Well, he got 10 yards. They just brought the sticks out to measure, and so he picks up 10. It's a first down, Notre Dame. The ball at their own 39-yard line.
The
minutes, 29 seconds remaining, third quarter of play here at Notre Dame Stadium. Irish on top of the Tigers, 10-3. Hunter wide right. And Pushka now is flipped to the left side. Rusty Leisha, quarterback, has them in the eye. Takes out, rides it off to his fullback. That's Carter sweeping to his left. He's going to be nailed back around the 38-yard line as he bounced off of the intended tackle and then swept outside. And this time, the Tigers were in pursuit. Willie Underwood coming across with Eddie Gethers and David Reed, and they haul him down. So it is marked at the 37-yard line now, a loss of two. It'll be second down and 12.
You know, Joe, there again, Carter is not billed as being one of the premier running backs in the country, and to say the least. And yet, they're missing some tackles on him out there.
Hunter comes left. Houlihan goes to the right side. They'll work from the eye. Second down, 12. Notre Dame at their own 37. Leish rolling left, looking to throw. Now going to run with it. Comes up to the 40, and down he goes. David Reed nails him there. Reed was in good position that time. He had made a drop on the short coverage, and when he saw Leish commit to run, he came up and was able to knock him down at the 38-yard line. They'll spot it. It's now third down on 11, Notre Dame. So here is a big play.
Well, Leish is certainly not your typical option rollout quarterback, is he?
Sweeney and Ferguson in that backfield. Houlihan goes right. Hunter splits left. Leish at quarterback. Takes out. Gives off to Ferguson. Vegas comes out across the 40 to about the 44, and that's it. He is knocked down at the 44-yard line on a delayed draw that time. Bubba Brown read it well and gets to Vegas Ferguson, so Notre Dame will turn over the football now. It's at the Irish 44-yard line, and Dick Pushka on to do the punting. Backed up deep, Hollis Hall for the Tigers.
7 yards. Dave Pushka back for
Notre Dame. Second time they punted today, Jim.
Whoops. Tigers almost jumped offside there. Pushka gets the kick away. It's a good one. Hollis Hall coming across, fumbles it, dives on it, back at the 18-yard line. So that's where the Tigers will put it in play, first and 10, after a punt of 38 yards by Pushka. Hollis Hall fielding it back at about the 14, fumbled it away, then dove on it at the 18, and that's where the Tigers take over first and 10. Well, they started from the 18 the last time. It was actually the 20, but Billy Lott lost 2 yards, and they had to begin from the 18. Now we've got a flag down next to the football, and a personal foul against Notre Dame is the indication.
Yeah, they're really protesting something down there.
A personal foul against the Irish is the call.
Mr. Devine wants to have a word with one of the officials.
Well, he's on the field, which is not abnormal for him. He likes to go out and chat. A foul against the Irish. That'll be 15 yards and bring it out to the 33-yard line, where the Tigers now start offensively.
Ball
8 minutes, 10 seconds remaining, third quarter. Brilliant, sunshiny day here in South Bend, Indiana. Very, very pleasant weather. Perry Tuttle wide to the left side. High formation. It's Chuck McSwain at tailback, Tracy Perry the fullback, and now the referee steps in. I believe they want a new football. Mark Thornton didn't like the one that he came up over that time.
Yeah, and Devine is taking the opportunity to have another chat with one of the officials, thinking he's inviting him for coffee later.
So the Tigers regroup in the huddle now, back at the 25-yard line. Tuttle again goes wide to the left side. They'll work with a two tight end offense. Billy Lott at quarterback. Up under center he goes as they're in the eye. Lott takes out, rolling to his left, looking to throw. Gets to the corner, now he's going to have to run with it. Comes up over the 35, gets to a 37, and down he goes there as he is met and spilled, this time by Hankard. And I believe we may get another personal foul call here against Notre Dame. Let's see. Is there a flag out there? I heard that Clemson crowd respond across the way.
Looks like a flag.
Looks like maybe another late hit against the Irish. They've had a lot of yardage and penalties here this afternoon called off against them. There's no question.
You know, Jim, that is so unnecessary, something like that to happen when you have a seven-point lead on a football team. To come out and just give them 30 yards in a couple of plays like that, when you know they are a better football team than they've been playing so far.
Well, it's into the 48-yard line of the Irish now. Gilliard is wide to the right side. Perry and McSwain in the eye behind Billy Lott. Lot up under center. Takes out. This time gives to Tracy Perry, and he's inside the 45 to the 42-yard line before he is pulled down. Now Jerry Gilliard being given a little talk out there by Dave Wehmer. Gilliard went down and threw on him, which is what the Clemson wide receivers do so well. They block downfield. So Wehmer got up a little yakety-yak. Shuttles back in. He comes wide to the right side. It's second down four for the Tigers. In at the 43-yard line of the Irish. Billy Lott pitch back to Chuck McSwain. Has some running room as he gets inside the 40. Down close to the 38. He'll be close to a first down. Let's see where it's marked.
The ball carrier.
I believe we'll have the... Yep, it is a first down. Clock stopped with 7:03 as they move the chain sticks now. The ball is in at the Irish 38-yard line. Leopold made that tackle on McSwain that time.
Getting down close to some orange folks sitting in the stands across the way, too.
All right, here's Gilliard. Wide to the right side as again they're in the eye. Now, again, the officials step in. I'm out here, and I don't know what. I don't think it's delay of game. Not really certain what it was all about, to tell you quite frankly.
Now, the referee pointed to the Tigers, but he didn't...
There was no infraction of any type. Ohio State is out of final. They came back. They're leading Michigan 18-50, and I don't know whether that's final or not. Ohio State and Michigan playing in their traditional battle. Here's Tracy Perry, and he's driving his way into about the 32-yard line before he is pulled down. And up front again, Dulcey over there, Nanny, Thornton at center, making the way. Zedek and Desiato were up defensively for Notre Dame. So mark it at the 32-yard line of the Irish. Second down, four for the Tigers. High formation with Tuttle wide to the right side. Billy Lott at quarterback, takes out. Rides it off, Chuck McSwain. Whoa, good job running by Chuck McSwain as he was stopped back around the 30 but kept his feet moving and drove for a couple of more into the 28-yard line before he was spilled. And they'll need about a foot for a first down here.
You know, just something that I find unusual. Notre Dame played a four-man line, a three-man line very successfully all during the first half. Now they've come out and run a five-man line quite a bit.
All right, Gilliard is wide to the right side. It's third and one Tigers inside the 30-yard line of the Irish. Billy Lott at quarterback. Takes out. Gives it off to Perry. First down as he's into about the 27-yard line. Tracy Perry gets the first down yardage at the 27-yard line of Notre Dame.
Perry, the ball carrier.
6 for 12 on third down conversion for the Tigers.
10-3, the Irish leading, but the Tigers now threatening. With 5:25 remaining here in the third quarter of play at Notre Dame Stadium in South Bend. High formation again. Tuttle wide to the right side. Lott has Tracy Perry and Chuck McSwain behind him. Takes out, pitch to McSwain, drops the football, and Lott has to fall on it. Boy, that could have been construed as a late hit there, I'll guarantee you. Anchored. Very fortunate, I would think, that he didn't get a hanky thrown because Lott was down on the ball when he popped him from behind.
This time, I don't think it was Lott's fault either. Looked like Chuck just did not handle it.
So it's back to the 33 now. Second down, 15 yards to go for the Tigers. Wide to the right side, Tuttle. Gilliard's a slot on the right side. They send Eric Young to the left. Billy Lott takes out. Rolling to his right, looking to throw. Fires. It is incomplete. Trapped down there by Tuttle. Ball was just a bit underthrown, and Perry was only able to trap it, not get to it. So now the Tigers face with a third down and 15 at the 33-yard line of the Irish. And this drive has stalled somewhat when McSwain lost possession of the football and Lott had the ball on it. Out they come. Eric Young to the left side. Tuttle wide right. Joey Smith, the slot on the right side. Lott rolling right. Now decides to run into the 30, into the 25, down to the 24-yard line. Not enough for a first down, but it does put the football directly in front of the goalpost and well within the range of Obed Arere. Remke brought him down. They spotted it at the 25, and Ariri now will attempt a field goal of 41 yards as it will be placed directly in front of the goalpost at the 31-yard line. Bo Blanton to hold.
Ariri will tie the field goal for Clemson.
Here's the snap, the spot. Ariri's kick is up. His kick is good. Ariri hits the 41-yard field goal. And now with 3:47 remaining here in the third quarter of play, there's timeout on the field with the score Notre Dame 10, the Tigers 6.
This is the Clemson Football Network.
Dabco Auto Parts Stores.
Dabco wants to help you get ready for winter with a Douglas, the Douglas battery. From a company that believes they have a product to fit your requirements. From a car to a riding lawnmower to the largest piece of off-the-road equipment. A Douglas is durable. You can depend on it despite the weather. And it's reasonably priced at your nearest Dabco store.
And you can find a Dabco store in Easley at Imperial Products.
82-yard drive, 6 minutes and 40 seconds. Ariri capped it off with a 41-yard field goal. Tigers now within striking distance. It's a 10-6 ball game. Tigers outrun Jim. And now Notre Dame has seemed very confused on a lot of things here in this quarter. They just have not played with the intensity that the Tigers lost early. I'm not counting the chickens, don't get me wrong. I'm saying now they have got to do some regrouping.
Well, two 15-yard penalties against Notre Dame obviously hurt them there. Yes. There is no question about that. Backed up deep now. Ty Barber to the near side. Jim Stone to the far side as Ariri places it on the tee at the 40-yard line at the north end of the Notre Dame Stadium. Ariri approaches the football. It's high, end over end kick. Going to be grabbed off. Barber's got it. Stone has it at the 15, out over the 20. Gets away to the 25, the 30, and Andy Hedden finally knocks him down at the 41-yard line. Andy Hedden over there, helped out by Randy Learn. So Notre Dame with good field position now at their own 41-yard line, and it's in the hands of the Tiger defense once again. Here comes Hunter to the near side. Houlihan will line up as a wing on the far side. The ride goes off to Vegas Ferguson. Ferguson is nailed around the 40. Ball went to the ground. The Tigers have the football at the 40-yard line. Jim Stuckey popped the ball loose. And let's see who came up with it. Who got it? Bubba Brown has the football. Stuckey, somebody called on the halftime show, Ken, and said, is Jim Stuckey playing today? I haven't heard his name. Well, I'll tell you, he just came up that time. He really slammed into Ferguson, and the ball popped out of there, and Bubba Brown got it. So the Tigers have it right back at the 40-yard line of the Irish. Duddle comes wide to the right side. In the eye, Billy Lott at the controls, as Tracy Perry and Chuck McSwain behind him. Lott takes out. McSwain gets the call. Chuck McSwain fumbles the ball into the air, and a scramble for it. The Tigers get it. Wow. That one was fumbled 10 feet up in the air. It bounced off of the hands of a couple of Notre Dame players and finally went down, and the Tigers come up with it as Jeff Bostic falls on it. Way to go, Jeff.
It kind of looked like 10 guys going up for a rebound.
Did look like a little action under the boards, didn't it? Well, they got about 3 yards on the play, so it'll be second down and 7 now. Lester Brown has checked in at tailback. Gilliard comes wide to the right side. Tracy Perry remains at fullback. Billy Lott up under center, takes out, pitch back, Lester Brown, Dolce out in front, Brown at the 35, down to about the 31-yard line. He'll be close to a first down. Let's see where they spot the football. Chris Dolce, the pulling guard on the play, leading the way for Lester Brown that time. And they will mark it at the 31-yard line. And let's see, it's going to be just shy by about a yard of being a first down. It will be third and one.
Jim, that guy holding the stick over there, the chain stick, did not drop it. He just held it up like somebody hit it.
Should have gotten out of the way, no question about it. Bubba Smith, a great football player. His career ended because of a similar circumstance. There's the ride to Perry. There's a first down as Tracy dives into the 29-yard line before he is hammered down. Tracy Perry makes it first down, Tigers. Bob Crable, the middle linebacker, stopped him.
That's five first downs for the Tigers. Now Notre Dame has one this half. They're 7-for-13 total in game and conversion.
First and 10 at the 29-yard line of Notre Dame. Gilliard wide to the right side. Tracy Perry and Lester Brown on the eye behind quarterback Billy Lott. Lott takes out. Pitch back. Here's Lester sweeping to his right. Turns downfield, gets into about the 27-yard line where he is knocked down. Good job defensively by Dave Wehmer, who came across and cut Lester's legs out from under him. They have marked it at the 26-yard line. So a gain of three. Second down and seven, Tigers.
Notre Dame used a split six that time, or a wide tackle six, something wide, spread out six-man front.
Well, Tigers have seen that more than once this year.
Yeah.
Maryland. 10-6, Notre Dame has the lead. Tigers in possession at the 26-yard line of the Irish. Out it comes. Billy Lott on a misdirect. He keeps. Lott to the 20. 15. Lott at the 10. The 5. Touchdown! There's a lot of orange in South Bend, Indiana, and right now it's all on its feet as Billy Lott rolled to his right. It was run all the way. He did a little misdirect on the spin around at the line of scrimmage, and then off he went for the score, and the Tigers have moved on top 12-10 as Obadiriri will come on and try and tack on the 13th point of the afternoon. The snap, the spot. Ariri's kick is up. His kick is good. Timeout on the field. The score, Tigers 13, the Irish 10.
This is the Clemson Football Network. Now at Jack Barry Chrysler Plymouth, you can buy any 1980 in stock, including Horizon, TC3, Arrow, and Arrow Truck at just 5% over factory invoice. Plus, you'll get a $300 check from Chrysler if you buy any new 1979 or 80 Volare, Cordoba, New Yorker, Newport, Grand Fury, Voyager, Trail Duster, or Lebanon. You'll agree that Jack Barry Chrysler Plymouth offers the highest quality, excellent mileage, and the best service, all at the lowest prices. And only from Jack Barry Chrysler Plymouth, 523 West Washington Street in Greenville.
After swooping down on a Vegas Ferguson fumble, the Tigers went 41 yards in 2 minutes and 17 seconds in 5 plays. Billy Lott, the last 27, all on his own for the touchdown. The PAT by Ariri, and now the Tigers are out front by a score of 13-10 over the Notre Dame Fighting Irish.
Well, we just got a score from the Southeastern Conference. Auburn is leading Georgia 16-10 in the third quarter. Here's Ariri's kick. High end over end. Stone waiting for it at the 13. Fumbles it. A big scramble for it, and the Tigers get it, lose it. Everyone's after it, and Clemson may have a touchdown here. Let's see. The ball is still loose. Notre Dame's got it in the end zone. That'll be a safety.
I don't believe that.
Nope, touchback. I'm sorry, touchback. I thought the Tigers had a touchdown there for sure. They had two or three players fall on it. The indication is a touchback. That'll bring it out to the 20, and the Irish will start from there. They just could not get on the bouncing ball. Again, last week, Notre Dame, on two occasions against Tennessee. One time, they fielded a kickoff at the one-yard line and went out of bounds with it. The next time Tennessee kicked off, Notre Dame fielded it at the two, fumbled it out of bounds at the seven. Now Stone fumbles one that almost gave the Tigers a touchdown, but the Irish have the football at the 20-yard line. Everybody and his brother had a shot at that ball, but it just kept bouncing away. Here's Rusty Leach bringing them out now. He's back to throw. He's looking for Hunter. He's going deep, and it is a complete or incomplete? No, incomplete. He was out of bounds when he came down with the football at the 47-yard line of the Tigers. That official had to come from a long way, but he was angled right down the sideline. He had a good view of the play. Lish. Rex Varn and Jack Kane were back covering that time on Hunter.
Lish was going to get it all back at one time.
Well, he just misfired, or he went might well have done just that. Now I'm stuttering.
I know you're not nervous.
13-10. Tigers have the lead with a minute 22 remaining in the third quarter now. Hunter is wide to the left side. Houlihan goes right. Back to throw is Lish. Screen pass. Ferguson drops it. Incomplete. Incomplete pass as Vegas Ferguson could not hang on. And so now it'll be third down and 10 for the Irish at their own 20.
With a minute 17 to go, it still looks like the Tigers are going to outscore opponents in the third quarter, if nothing else, as they've come storming back to pick up 13 third quarter points right here against the Irish. But there's a lot of football left.
Believe me. All right, they've got Dickerson in now. He comes wide to the left side. Houlihan goes to the right. Sweeney and Ferguson in the backfield as Lish goes back to throw. Being chased. Now fires a screen to Ferguson. Incomplete again. Well covered that time by the Tigers' Steve Durham, who was right with Vegas Ferguson as he came out in the left flat. Was it Stuckey? No, Stuckey had the pressure on Lish, no question. Right, yep. But Durham it was who was right with Ferguson.
Got to say, one of the few times they're beginning to get to Lish now and forcing him to throw the ball sooner than he wants to sometimes.
Dick Pushka on to do the punting now for the Irish of Notre Dame. Tigers leading at 13-10 here in the third quarter with a minute 11 remaining. Snap back. Pushka gets it. Gets his kickoff. This one is grabbed by Hollis Hall, who fumbles it. And thankfully, the Tigers get it. Is coming up with it over there. Falling on it was Anthony Rose. Hollis has had a little bit of a problem hanging on to the punts here this afternoon. 42-yard punt by Pushka, and the Tigers with the football at their own 38-yard line.
But, you know, for Clemson, that's not bad field position.
Oh, no, good field position.
Good thing to work
for. Hate to see that ball squirt out like that. All right, out they come. It'll be Marvin Sims and Lester Brown in the eye. Tuttle is wide to the right side as Billy Lott at quarterback. Takes out. Pitch back to Lester. Lester, 40. Out to the 43. Lott takes out. Rides to Marvin Sims. Marvin straight ahead. Bulls his way over the 45 to the 46-yard line, and the Tigers will be faced with a third and two now at their own 46-yard line. Bostic and Gary Brown were blocking out in front. Crable and Zedek up defensively for Notre Dame. Now a big third down play again for the Tigers. Third down and two at their own 46-yard line.
One thing Clemson needs to do, Jim, is to go on about their business, just keep up with their game plan, continue to play football.
The three-quarter has just ended. The clock runs down after three quarters of play. The score, Clemson 13, Notre Dame 10.
That big twin at party, there's nothing to satisfy. Fries, those twin burgers, and all that cheese. Topped with a sauce, that's a real surprise.
Round here, you can get burgers at more places you can shake a stitch at. Good burgers, too, but nothing. Nothing I know measures up to a Hardee's Big Twin. You take a Big Twin, and you have got yourself a pile of goodies. Pure beef burgers, tangy cheese, crisp lettuce, special sauce, all on a tasty bun. Now that's as good as a burger gets. Twice as good as a burger gets.
When I found Hardee's, best eating in town, up and down, all around.
All right, we're back at Notre Dame Stadium. It's a big third down and two for the Tigers at their own 47-yard line. Tuttle is wide to the left as Billy Lott brings them out of the... Officials indicating timeout, and let's see where the ball is spotted now. It's... Going to bring the chain sticks in, but I believe he's got enough for the first down.
Yeah, I agree with you on this one. Little guessing from up here.
I think Notre Dame is aware that he has a first down, too, because their defense stands out there looking a little perplexed. Yeah, he's got it by a yard. Out at the 49-yard line, first down for the Tigers as Lester Brown hit over the right side and carried for the first down. Back in the huddle now. They'll bring Gilliard wide to the left side. Brown and Sims in the eye, tailback and fullback respectively as Billy Lott moves up under center. Lott now takes out. Marvin Sims straight ahead. He goes into Notre Dame territory to the 45-yard line. Rosetic brings him down. Marvin gets so much body lean that he's almost going down before anyone hits him, actually. And if he could get a little more erect in his running out there, he gets a lot of good, tough yards, but boy, one of these days he could pop one if he didn't lean so hard. Well, Marvin's injured, too, as he comes to the sidelines. Well, Tracy Perry has moved back in at fullback. Try and get a report on Marvin Sims as quickly as we can. Here's the ride to Perry. Perry busts his way straight ahead, and he may have a first down as he's in near the Notre Dame 40-yard line before he is hit by Tom Gibbons. See, they needed to get to the hash mark, and they did get up and across the hash mark, and that will be first down. They're going to measure nonetheless, but they've got a first down. I can see it from here.
Can we certainly hope that Marvin is not hurt, but the...
What's the indication? What are they doing?
I can't tell over there without my binoculars.
First and 10, Tigers hit at the 41-yard line of the Irish. Clemson on top in this game, 13-10 with 13 minutes and 52 seconds remaining. Out they come, Gilliard wide to the left side. High formation, two tight end offense. Billy Lott at quarterback on first down. Takes out, pitches back. Lester Brown sweeping wide left. Thrown for a loss back at the 47-yard line. Getting to him was Joe Grampke. Blocking, falling down up front that time. And Grampke sifting on through was able to get to Lester back at the 47. That's a loss of six that brings about second and 16.
Jim, what I was going to say, I hope, of course, that Marvin is not hurt, but you haven't hurt your football team at all when you put Tracy Perry in at fullback.
Oh, no
question
about that.
That's one thing for sure.
Out they come again. Tuttle this time goes wide to the right side. Billy Lott at quarterback. Takes out. Misdirect. Here's Lott. Lott into the 41. That's back to the original line of scrimmage. And Billy was about a step away for going for long yardage again that time. He has worked the misdirect beautifully. And I talked with Danny Ford about that on the pregame show, Ken. He said that Billy felt like he could do it. They put it in a couple of weeks ago, and he just seems to get better with it.
Well, Billy has really matured as time has gone along. He's had some ups and downs, but Billy was not the most experienced quarterback in the nation when the season started.
They'll go to three wideouts now on third down and 9. Lott up under center. Brings Gilliard in motion to the left. Billy back to throw. Pressure on him. Running now. Turns the corner at the 40. 35. Needs a couple of more and may have it. He got down in for a first down, I believe, as he is stopped down around the 31-yard line. Just short by inches, it's going to be.
Stopped by Leopold.
It's right over by the chain sticks, and I think it's going to be short just by inches. Boy, that was a tremendous job of scrambling by quarterback Billy Lott. Just inches from being a first down as he got it into the 31-yard line of Notre Dame.
Almost as close they can't measure.
Well, he had rolled to his left, and he got the defense coming his way. And when he turned and went back against the grain, he had a lot of wide open spaces. So it is fourth down and inches for the Tigers at the 31-yard line of Notre Dame.
Ohio State 18, Michigan 15.
18-15, Ohio State has won the Big Ten. They defeat Michigan this afternoon. The Buckeyes 10-0 on the year and Rose Bowl bound. Gilliard wide to the left. Fourth down inches for the Tigers. Billy Lott, I don't know. He was hit as he came forward with the football. Let's see whether he gets it or not.
Lott the ball carrier.
I'm Lott sneaking. And let's see whether he gets it or not. The officials down in there digging for the ball now.
You don't think Billy would try to inch it forward, do you?
Oh, not much. No, that when he was hit and his forward progress stopped, that official immediately coming from the far side marked it. Now they stretch it out, a very big measurement here. Stretch it out, and it is first down for the Tigers.
Oh. Could not have been any closer.
And those 5,000-plus Tiger fans reveling in their team's first down. 12 minutes left in this game. 13-10. Clemson on top. Jerry Tuttle wide to the left side. High formation in behind Billy Lott at quarterback. Lott moves up under center, takes out, gives it off to Tracy Perry. Tracy stays on his feet and drives into the 25-yard line before he is pulled down. And coming across defensively this time for Notre Dame was Bob Crable.
Stopped by Grampke.
So Perry gets 6 big yards that time. It's second down and 4.
lot of football was showing when Lott came out from under center that time.
Gilliard wide to the left side. Again, they're in the eye. Lester Brown at tailback. Tracy Perry, the fullback. Billy Lott takes out, rides it off to Perry again. Tracy straight away, hammers his way in close to a first down at the 21-yard line before Crable brings him down again. Ken, they came out here in this football game this afternoon a lot in the first half using three wideouts. Now they've gone back to the basics the second half almost exclusively. They've run the double tight end offense. They have begun to move with their running game. Here's Marvin Sims checking back in. So evidently, whatever it was not of a serious nature. So Sims is back in at fullback. And Lester Brown, the tailback, on third and a foot. And Billy Lott keeps and goes straight ahead, and I think he's got the first down. Yep, he's got it. Football is almost to the 20-yard line, and that'll be good for another Tiger first down here.
11 for 15.
Marvin Sims checks out immediately. He is walking just a little gingerly on that right leg.
You know, Jim, you were talking about the Tiger offense, and also this time Notre Dame has had so much trouble diagnosing it, they've used about five different defenses, it appears to us.
Where does drive begin?
At 38.
All right, here's Gilliard wide to the left side as Lott sets them down in the eye. Tracy Perry is back in a fullback. Lester Brown gets the call, cracks over left tackle inside the 20 to the 18-yard line, and hit there by Zedek and Gramke. So about 3 yards on first down. It'll be second down and seven now for the Tigers. 9 minutes and 50 seconds remaining here in the fourth quarter of this football game at Notre Dame Stadium in South Bend, Indiana, on this beautiful campus at Notre Dame. Out they come. Tuttle is wide to the left side as Billy Lott moves up under center, takes out, rides it off to Perry. Tracy straight ahead, then bounces off and goes to his right and gets maybe 1 yard as he's into the 17, and there is a flag on the play. A flag on the play.
Quite a bit of some delay there, huh?
Illegal procedure against the Tigers.
A flag on the play.
This drive's a little over 6 minutes old already.
So they discuss it now with Notre Dame. The Irish may refuse this penalty.
Yeah, they're getting the indication from Devine.
Yep. I believe I would if I were in their shoes, because it still leaves Clemson with third down now and about 8 yards to go, 7 yards to go for a first down. And, of course, if you penalize them, of course, you give them an extra down. And at this point, Notre Dame needs the football, so they want the down to roll to number three. So now another big third down for the Tigers. Jeff McCall has just checked in. He'll run at fullback. Lester Brown is a tailback. And Billy Lott sends Tuttle wide to the left. Lott rolling to his left. Now he's going to be hemmed in and knocked down at the 20-yard line. So they'll have to call on Obed Ariri. Now here is where a touchdown really would have made a difference, because that would have a field goal here only puts the Tigers on top by 6 points, is what it all boils down to, and a lot of time on the clock.
You know, Jim, that time Lott ran over Lester Brown in the backfield. They bumped together back there like Lester was over to protect him, but he didn't really get out of the way.
Well, had he jumped just a little quicker, had Billy started to run a little quicker, I think he could have gotten a lot of yardage, but he delayed, and that allowed the defense to come across. Now, timeout has been asked by the Tigers. They stop the clock with 8 minutes, 37 seconds remaining in the game. And the score here at Notre Dame Stadium is Clemson 13, Notre Dame 10.
This is the Clemson Football Network. You know, building can be complicated. Let Argo uncomplicate things for you. With Argo, you'll get a complete design-build package for your individual construction needs. Experience, talent, expertise, dedication, and teamwork with a strong desire to please and provide construction services for their clients. That's Argo, your complete builder. In pursuit of excellence, more than a motto, it's a working creed, constantly pursued at Argo.
Obed Ariri will attempt a field goal of 37 yards directly in front of the goalpost. He's hit two this afternoon. Blanton to hold the spot. The kick is up. It's got the distance. The kick is good. Obed Ariri has hit his third field goal of the afternoon, and with timeout on the field, the score, Clemson 16, Notre Dame 10.
This is the Clemson Football Network.
Jeffco Auto Parts.
last time you saw a car stalled at the side of the road with the hood up and the steam pouring into the sky? Well, the winter months are hard on your car's cooling system. DAPCO wants to remind you to have your car's cooling system checked before the cold weather sets in. And when you do, ask for Gates Quality Cooling System products. You'll find them at your DAPCO store.
And there's a DAPCO store nearest you in Greer at Greer Auto Parts.
Okay, 8 minutes, 2 seconds. 62 yards. The Tigers with a reary. 37 yards out. He punched another one over, and now the Tigers holding on to a 16-10 lead here, trying to protect that as they have to give the ball back to the Fighting Irish.
Stone to the near side, Barber to the far side. It's up to the Tiger defense once again now. They know where it lies. O'Reary's high kick will be grabbed off by Stone 4 yards into the end zone. He'll touch it down there. It'll come out to the 20-yard line and be placed down with first and 10 for Notre Dame. Obed, with that wind behind him, booted that one into the end zone. That's what, 7 in a row now for Obed?
7 field goals in a row. 4 last week.
Well, yeah, he had that early season slump, but he has certainly come out of it. Now the Irish fans on their feet, behind their team. Wide left goes Houlihan. Hunter to the near side. Lish has Sweeney and Ferguson in the eye. Gives to Vegas Ferguson, sweeping to his left, but Jim Stuckey got him and hauls him down at the line of scrimmage. Stuckey came from his left tackle position across behind the line of scrimmage to grab Ferguson before he could go beyond the line of scrimmage.
You know, the Tigers have to be very careful not to overplay the run, because Lish, one of these big, tall receivers, can tie this thing up with one strike.
Carter and Ferguson in the backfield. To the left goes Hunter, to the near side, Houlihan. Rusty Lish takes out. He's back to throw. Firing deep down the far side. It's complete to Carter, or Hunter, and Hunter out to the 40-yard line before Terry Kennard and Rex Barn bring him down. Well, there he is. Big Tony Hunter, 6'5", a freshman. What a target to throw to. And Houlihan on the other side at 6'4".
Their second first down this half.
First and 10 at the 40-yard line of Notre Dame with 7 minutes, 42 seconds remaining in the football game, and the Tigers nursing a 16-10 lead. Hunter goes to the far side. Houlihan comes to the near side. High formation again behind Lish. He's back to throw, rolling to his right. Now being chased, looking downfield. Now going to go back against the grain, and he's got some room now. Comes up to the 40. David Reed misses him. Jeff Davis fumbles the ball, and the Irish recover at midfield. Tech came up with the loose football. Jeff Davis made the hit that shook it loose. That may be enough for an Irish first down on a play that saw Lish rolling to his right, hemmed in, but doing an outstanding job of getting back against the grain and carrying for perhaps a first down. It is a first down Irish.
He ran about 60 yards on that.
7:14 left in this football game. Dominating the first half of play. The Tigers dominating the third quarter and the first 7 minutes of this quarter, but now the Irish on the move. Houlihan's a wing to the left side as Hunter goes out split left. Houlihan in motion. Here's the give off this time to Ferguson. He'll be knocked down for no gain on the play. Grabbing him that time, Steve Durham. So mark it at the 49-yard line of the Tigers. Second down and 10 for Notre Dame. Sweeney gets back in now at fullback as Carter checks out.
Okay, Notre Dame has had such luck in two or three areas, of course, with Ferguson running and sometimes with the fullback and the throwing of Lish, so you've got to defense a whole lot of things.
Houlihan to the right. Hunter goes to the left side. Lish takes out, dropping to throw. Chased by Stuckey, gets away. Now firing over the middle, incomplete. Down at the 35-yard line of the Tigers, his intended receiver on that play, I got to check, it looked like one of the backs. No, it was his tight end, Dean Maztek. And Willie Underwood was there to break it up. So it is now third down and 10 for Notre Dame. Ball at the Tiger 49-yard line. Stone checks back in. And Barber comes in. Vegas Ferguson checks out.
Devine used a lot of running backs back there, especially the fullback slot. They've, what, used three already today?
I'll tell you what. don't be surprised if maybe they throw to one of those two backs that just went in there. One back set in behind. That is Barber. Everyone else is wide, and Lish is dropping the throw. Gets time. Fires over the middle. He's got Hunter. He's at the 25, and down he goes. They'll mark it at the 26-yard line. Tony Hunter, the big split end. Rex Barn and Willie Underwood haul him down, but there's a flag back upfield. A flag back upfield. Going to be pass interference against the Tigers. I believe Notre Dame will go with the play, however, because that interference call came up around the 41-yard line. So the Irish will have it first and 10 at the Tiger 26-yard line with 6:10 remaining in the game.
The passing ball team can get hunts of yardage so quickly.
Carter and Ferguson will be in that backfield now. Notre Dame started this drive at their own 20-yard line. Houlihan goes to the left. Hunter comes to the right. Two outstanding receivers, but Hunter has been the big man today. Lich takes out, gives it off to the first man through, and that is Carter, who is nailed as he gets into about the 25 by David Reed and Bubba Brown.
Stop by Reed.
Their backs love to come to the line of scrimmage and make contact and then bounce off and drift outside. That time, the Tigers had good flow with their defense. Five minutes, 27 seconds remaining. 16-10, Clemson on top. Notre Dame with the football. They send Hunter wide to the left side. Barber and Ferguson are the back. Houlihan comes to the right. And Lish is back to throw. Looking, firing, knocked down at the line of scrimmage. Batting that one down, I believe, was Charlie Bauman. Bauman got the hands up and knocked it down, or was it maybe perhaps Jeff Bryant? It was one of those two, but it was a deflected pass without question.
I could not tell, Jim, the Tigers are now...
I believe it might have been Bryant. It was a bigger man than Bauman who knocked it down.
They have a four front, by the way, using that extra defensive back in there.
Third down and 9 for Notre Dame. The ball at the 25-yard line of the Tigers. Hunter goes wide to the left side. Houlihan to the near side. Lish is back to throw. Looking for Hunter over the middle, fires. It is incomplete, intercepted. Terry Kennard got it. 10, 15, 20. Kennard to the 25-yard line. Willie Underwood, who was on pass protection against Hunter, batted it away. Terry Kennard picks it off. The Tigers have it at their own 25-yard line. So the Tigers back in possession of the football now. Tuttle comes wide to the left side. Lester Brown at tailback. Tracy Perry the fullback as Billy Lott at quarterback moves up under center. Takes out. Rides it off to Perry. Tracy straight ahead, and he's out to the 33-yard line. 15 seconds for station identification on the Clemson Football Network.
This is the Clemson Football Network. This is WFBC AM and FM stereo in Greenville, South Carolina. It's 3:58.
All right, Tigers set to go. They have the football at their 33-yard line. Second down and 3. Lot takes out. Flags go down. I think we had a little motion out there that time.
Somebody on the right side of the Tiger line looks like moved the arm.
It's either Bostic or Gary Brown, I believe. So that'll cost them 5. And now, instead of second down and 3, the Tigers will be faced with a second down pretty close to 10, probably about 8. They marked it at the 23 or the 27-yard line, so it's going to be second down and 7 yards to go for the Tigers now. At the 28-yard line, I beg your pardon. Tuttle comes wide to the left side. 4 minutes, 25 seconds left in the football game. Billy Lott at quarterback has them in the eye. Takes out. Billy on a misdirect. He's turning upfield. He gets out across the 35 to the 36, and Billy Lott has a first down. Tom Gibbons brought him down, but Billy Lott, with another big misdirect play, gets the first down for the Tigers at their own 36-yard line.
A lot of people were getting upset with Billy earlier in the ball game because of a couple of bad pitch outs, and maybe sometime when he... I see people during halftime say, well, he should have thrown a couple of times when he didn't. Well, he's come back this half.
Gilliard wide to the right side. They'll line up in the eye with Perry and Brown. Watt at quarterback. Up under center, takes out, gives to Tracy Perry, rams straight ahead, gets out near the 40-yard line, and is hammered down by Joe Gramsci, the defensive end for Notre Dame. 3 minutes, 40 seconds left in this football game. Tigers leading it 16-10. They'll have second down, 6 yards to go at their own 40-yard line. They need a couple of first downs.
You know, Jim, they came off the ball so fast that time, I thought they were offside.
I did, too. Quite frankly, I thought they had moved ahead of the snap. Tuttle goes wide to the right side. Billy Lott at quarterback, barking out the signals. Takes out. He's rolling to his right, looking to throw. Fires downfield. It is incomplete for Tuttle, in at the 43-yard line of Notre Dame. Back covering was Tom Desiato. Surprised me when he threw there, I'll guarantee you that.
Surprised me when Tuttle got up, too.
Yeah, he was popped pretty good. Good defensive play, though, by Desiato. So now it is third down. 6 yards to go for the Tigers at their own 40-yard line. Final, Auburn beats Georgia 33, fourth quarter, I beg your pardon. In the fourth quarter, 33-13, Auburn leading Georgia. Here's a big third down play for the Tigers. Billy Lott gives off to Lester Brown. Lester, going ahead, will only get to the 43-yard line, and the Tigers will have to punt it back over to Notre Dame with 3:04 remaining in the game. Hang on to your hat. David Sims gone to do the punting. The Tigers leading 16-10, 2 minutes, 52 seconds left. Backed up, Durson and Gibbons. Gibbons to the near side, Durson to the far side for the Irish. Snap back. Sims gets the kickoff. He has hit one high and far. That is Gibbons grabbing it at the 11, swinging to the left. And down he goes at about the 16 or 17-yard line. A 46-yard punt by David Sims, but now the Irish in possession of the football with 2:34 remaining in the game.
Jim, they gambled on a little bit of a rush that time. Didn't get the run back.
And now, the Irish fans on their feet, urging Rusty Lish to get something going, as he has John Sweeney and Vegas Ferguson in the running back position, sends Hunter to the right side, Houlihan to the far side. Lich takes out, pitch back, here is an end around, and a halfback pass, Houlihan looking to throw, firing deep downfield. This one is going to be intercepted. Bubba Brown, midfield, 45, 40, Bubba at the 30, 25, and down to the 29 line. Is it Kennard or Bubba? I thought it was Bubba.
I thought it was
Terry Kennard, I beg your pardon. Number 43. I thought it was Bubba all the way, but it was Terry Kennard. And did you see him set up his blockers as he came back with it? They tried a little razzle-dazzle as they reversed to Houlihan. He went back. He threw a dying quail. And look at Kennard as he races to the sidelines, a happy young man. And the Tigers have it with 2:17 remaining at the 20-yard line of Notre Dame.
A pass that should never have been thrown.
Who cares? All right, Billy Lott up under center now. Tigers have it at the 20 of Notre Dame. Gives off. Tracy Perry bounces off a tackler, comes to his left. He's at the 20, and down he goes at the 16-yard line. Boy, Tracy bounced out of there, and there must have been 20 people lying down on a pile there. Billy Lott got up and came over to give Tracy a block. Strung him outside for about 4 yards.
Yeah, Billy turned around and saw what had happened, and I also think McSwain was trying to get a block in there, too.
All right. Tuttle goes wide to the right side. The ball's at the 16-yard line of the Irish. 2 minutes, 10 seconds remaining in the game. Oh, Lott fumbles. Big scramble for it. Who's got it? Notre Dame. Good heavens. The Irish have it right back.
First turnover the Tigers have had today. Somebody's hurt.
Billy Lott fumbled the snap. Tracy Perry is not injured. I think he is just dejected.
Yeah.
2 minutes, 2 seconds left in the football game. Notre Dame has the football at their own 16. That's where they were moments ago. And listen to these Irish fans here at Notre Dame Stadium. Houlihan to the left side. Hunter comes to the near side. Sweeney and Ferguson, the running back. Lish is back to throw. Looking. Being chased. Durham got him back at the 2-yard line. Steve
the sack on Rusty Leach back at the 2-yard line. A minute 45 showing on the scoreboard clock, and Notre Dame going to stop it with a timeout. So there is timeout on the field with the score, Clemson 16, the Irish 10.
This is the Clemson Football Network.
Your nearest Dapco store.
And you can find a Dapco store in Woodruff at Ron's Auto Parts.
42 seconds to go. The Tigers nursing a fragile six-point lead. 16-10 over the Notre Dame Fighting Irish. Irish backed up against the wall. Have the ball back at their own 2-yard line. They're huddling in the end zone, and here they come, Jim.
All right, out over the football now comes Notre Dame. Rusty Leach will send Houlihan to the left. Brings Hunter to the near side. Wing to the right side also. That's Ferguson. Back to throw is Leach. Fires one. Completed this time. Over the middle, that's to his tight end, Maztak, who's out to about the 15-yard line where he is knocked down by Bob Goldberg. Clock at a minute and a half. Notre Dame will go without a huddle. Ball at their own 15-yard line. Split backfield. Hunter to the near side. Houlihan to the far side. Leach back to throw. Looking for Houlihan on a down and out, and it's batted away. Batted down by Steve Durham, who was coming on a hard rush. And it now is third down, 11 for Notre Dame. Well, they've chalked up fourth down. It is fourth down. Fourth down, 11 for the Irish. I lost track of downs. A minute, 16 seconds. The clock stopped on the incomplete pass. So here it is, folks. Houlihan to the left, Hunter to the right. Leach takes out, drops the throw, pressure on him, looking to throw, fires over the middle, it is incomplete, almost intercepted by Hollis Hall, but the Tigers have held in their field position, is at the 15-yard line of the Irish. That's better than an intercept by Hollis Hall back at the 40, I'll guarantee you. A minute nine remaining, and the Tigers have the football back, and as Jeff Bryant goes to the sidelines, he is embraced by Mike Bugar, and the two of them just fall in a big pile along the sidelines. Well, the rush was responsible here on that series. They got to Leach.
They finally got to him this half. He was taking apart the short passes earlier.
Minute nine left in the ball game. Billy Lott brings them out. Tracy Perry at fullback. Whoops. Were they drawn offside, or did Notre Dame come on their own? Let's see.
No, somebody moved. Tiger. Jeff Bostic.
Jeff with a false start, so that'll cost them five. It'll move it back out to the 20-yard line. Minute, 8 seconds left in the football game. Tigers on top, 16-10. They have the football at the 20-yard line of Notre Dame, first down and 15.
Tigers, of course, going to take all the time they possibly can to block and stop right now, but between any plays, they're going to take time.
Tuttle goes wide to the right side. They're in the eye. Billy Lott at quarterback, setting them down. Up under center, takes out. Billy Keeps goes straight ahead. He's into about the 17 or 18-yard line before he is pulled down in there. And now Notre Dame will request a timeout. With a minute, 2 seconds remaining. Timeout on the field. The score, Tigers 16, Notre Dame 10.
This is the Clemson Football Network.
Here in the Piedmont area, the people are as sharp as they come. They know that most of the time you get what you pay for. And that's why Michelin X steel belted radios are so popular. With Michelin's on your car, you know you're getting all the performance a quality set of tires is designed to deliver. So, if you need tires, see the people at the Tire Exchange for Michelin X radials. You'll certainly be glad you did. The Tire Exchange, 801 North Main Street, Simpsonville. Also locations in Greenville, Greer, and Malden.
Notre Dame has a couple of timeouts left now with a minute two to go after using that one to stop the clock. It's one left, I'm sorry. Okay, I was looking at the clock. And
one timeout remaining for Notre Dame, right. Billy Lott moves up under center now. Takes out. Again, he just falls forward with the football. And once more, Notre Dame quickly getting a timeout. Stopping the clock with 56 seconds remaining.
No game. Timeout, Notre Dame.
Okay, this is going to bring up a situation. Third and, 15 almost, 14?
Third and 14 is what it'll be. Ball at the 19-yard line of Notre Dame. Tigers on top, 16-10. They trailed 10-0 at the half.
But they just dive on the ball one more time since they've used their last timeout.
Well, they can...
So they got two more plays, yeah.
30 seconds.
Yeah.
25 seconds, beg your pardon. Get 50 of the 56 out of the way and take a delay of game and let Ovid try to kick one, maybe.
You know, that contingent of Tiger fans has really made a lot of noise across the way.
They haven't
slowed down tonight, and at times you thought they were the majority here.
Ken, I've never seen anything like it. There was a group of 30 or 40 or so Tiger fans who were greeting the team at the airport when they flew into South Bend yesterday. Billy Lott again falls on the football. This time Notre Dame will not be able to get a timeout. The clock will run. They'll take a delay of game. And then will they call on Ovid? Or will they just... You've got to call on Ovid, don't you?
Well, you've got to do something. You don't want to give him the ball right back.
Fourth down.
Yeah. You know, any... With a six-point lead, if you had an eight-point or nine-point lead...
26 seconds, 25, 24... Clock down to 22 seconds, 21, 20 seconds. Tigers break from the huddle. There's the delay of game with 17 seconds remaining. And now let's see if Ovid Ariri does come in.
They don't seem to be making a move across the way.
No, they don't.
That's not their thinking.
They'll march it back out to the 24-yard line.
It's an unusual situation. I don't know when I've seen one like this, Jim. You've got to have a decision like this to make. You give them the ball.
Well, you obviously do not pass the football.
You don't want to kick
them out
block.
And run a play. Lester Brown, a tailback. Tracy Perry, the fullback. Again, Billy Lott just falls on the football. It's 14 seconds left as Notre Dame has it at the 26-yard line.
Like a scramble play weapon. I don't know. Over there.
Now it's in the hands of the defense once again. And 14 seconds still remaining on the scoreboard clock. Out comes Notre Dame. Rusty Lish at quarterback brings Hunter to the near side. Sends Houlihan to the far side, and Lish is back to throw, obviously. Going deep over the middle. This one is incomplete. Clock stopped with 8 seconds now as Hunter was the intended receiver. The ball thrown over him and out of bounds down around the 35 of the Tigers.
And was Kennard so careful not to have an interference call on him? He looked like he was tiptoeing out there.
Laid off. He knew where the ball was thrown. Second down and 10, Notre Dame. 8 seconds left in the game. Tigers leading at 16-10. Vegas Ferguson checks out.
Got a good hand.
Wide left Hunter to the near side, Houlihan. Rusty Lish, quarterback, back to throw, fires over the middle. This one is complete for Houlihan. Bubba Brown knocks him down at the 47-yard line. 1 second left on the clock. Timeout on the first down with 1 second left in the game.
Yeah, you can't let up here.
Well, of course, they'll start that clock as soon as they get the chain sticks moved and the ball spotted. As soon as the referee winds it down. Now the clock winds. And it is all over.
Wait a minute.
It is all over.
Wait a minute.
Fans on the field. Illegal procedure against Notre Dame declined by the Tigers. Don't you worry about that. Wait a minute. The Tigers have come in to South Bend, and they have defeated the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame here this afternoon after trailing 10-0 at the half. The Tigers came out, played as everyone felt they were capable of playing, and they win it here this afternoon. We'll be back to wrap it up shortly. That final score, Tigers 16, Notre Dame 10.
Beer makes it good. There's no debate. Beer makes it good. Schlitz makes it great.
Every day, millions of